City of New York City, the Pittsburgh Steelers and the football Giants. And for the Pittsburgh Steelers, who will receive? At left end, number 85, Gary Bowman. At left tackle, number 77, Dan James. At left guard, number 62, Mike Sandusky. At center, number 51, Buzz Nutter. At right guard, number 72, Ray Lemick. At right tackle, number 71, Charlie Bradshaw. At right end, number 40, Preston Carpenter. At left halfback, number 33, Deron Sapp. At fullback, number 35, John Henry Johnson. At quarterback, number 15, Ed Brown. At right halfback, flankerback, number 84, Buddy Dial. For the Giants, defensively, at left end, number 75, Jim Katkavich. Left tackle, number 77, Dick Moduleski. At right tackle, number 76, John Lovettier. At right end, number 81, Andy Robustelli. The left linebacker, number 87, Jerry Hillebrand. The middle linebacker, number 70, Sam Huff. The right linebacker, number 82, Tom Scott. Defensively, the left cornerback, number 49, Erich Barnes. The left safety, number 25, Dick Pessman. The right safety, number 20, Jim Patton. And the right cornerback, number 22, Dick Lynch. The Pittsburgh Steelers being introduced, and here's Marty Glickman.
Thank you, Joe Hassel. Good afternoon, everyone. As Joe indicated to you, the skies are clear. The weather is crisp and clear. Temperature in the high 20s. The condition of the field is actually varied, if I can put it that way. At the close end of Yankee Stadium, and from the 30-yard line down towards the goal line, the field is frozen almost completely solid. From that point out to about the 30-yard line on the open end of the stadium, it's partly solid and partly soft. And it's soft in the 30-yard line in at the open end of Yankee Stadium. So the footing may be uncertain in different parts of the field during the course of the afternoon. Both ball clubs are wearing cleats. It may be necessary to change the sneakers later this afternoon when the temperature drops, as it probably will during the course of the game. The field is entirely, almost entirely in shadow, only about the 30-yard line in at the open end of Yankee Stadium and diagonally towards the goal line is it now still in sunshine. And very soon, the lights will be turned on here at Yankee Stadium, so there won't be a such difference during the course of the afternoon, during the course of the game, when it becomes so dark that the lights must be turned on. You probably can judge from the roar of the crowd that the Giants are now being introduced and the defensive unit is making its appearance on the field. John Lovettier, Dick Moduleski, Andy Robustelli, Jim Katkavich, the front four, Jerry Hillebrand, Sam Huff, Tom Scott, the linebackers, and the deep four of Eric Vaughn, Dick Pessinen, Jim Patton, and Dick Lynch. Alex Webster is in uniform today. He may play. He will not start. Here's one of the Giants out there wearing sneakers. That's Jerry Hillebrand wearing basketball shoes. We can note the difference immediately. Sneakers are white that he is wearing. The rest of the ball club thus far in black football shoes. So one of the Giants at least is wearing sneakers today. Talked to Coach Ollie Sherman on the field before the game. He said he would recommend to his ball club that they wear cleats. And now as the rest of the Giants squad comes running on the field, we see that several of them are wearing sneakers. Ken Byers, for one, is wearing sneakers. And I think Jerry Hillebrand, I know, is. And Lane Howell is also wearing sneakers. 11 weeks ago, the Pittsburgh Steelers trounced the Giants of Pittsburgh 31-0. I'm sure you know that Y.A. Tittle did not play in that game. In a long rivalry between these two teams, the Giants have won 32 games, Pittsburgh 21. Two games have ended in ties. This is the 56th game between these two teams in regular season competition. If the Giants win today or tie, they win the Eastern Division Championship. If Pittsburgh wins, they win the Eastern title. Pittsburgh will have a record of 8 wins, 3 losses, and 3 ties. Disregard the ties. The record would be 8-3 for a winning percentage of .727. If Pittsburgh wins, the Giant record would be 10-4, and their record would be .714. So by percentage points, Pittsburgh would win the title if they win the ball game today. If this game winds up in a tie, the Giants will have a percentage of .769, and Pittsburgh 700. The Giants would win the championship. And, of course, if the Giants win, that's it. Of course, the other most important ball game today is at Chicago between the Detroit Lions and the Chicago Bears. And if Chicago wins those ties in that game, they win the Western Division championship. If Detroit wins that game, then the Green Bay Packers, who defeated San Francisco yesterday 21-17, Green Bay will have successfully defended the championship. But those are the various developments which this afternoon will bring to a close. And the two captains have met at midfield. The Giants lost the toss. Pittsburgh will be receiving. For a word or two before we get into the ball game, let's call on Al DeRogatis.
Well, Marty, you can really sense the great enthusiasm. Not only did I sense it in the locker room, but you can sense it here. The fans have really picked this up. And Marty, I look forward to a really great first quarter. These boys, both teams seem extremely loose, and I think we'll see some really ferocious hitting. Probably the Steelers will try to contain the football, keep it on the ground, see whether they can establish a running game. So a great of the weight now will rest on the Giants' big four and the big three linebackers. It should be a really great first quarter.
New York Giants are strung out along their own 35-yard line. They're wearing the home uniforms, the blue. Gary Baldwin and Clinton Thomas back at the goal line are ready for the kickoff. Don Chandler moves forward and boots the ball. A low kick, end over end, bounding down into the end zone. And Clinton Thomas picks it up. And falling down in front of him was Gary Borman, who slipped. He's wearing cleats, and that's the closed, frozen portion of the field. Clinton Thomas did not run it out. It's an automatic touchback. And it's first and 10 now for the Pittsburgh Steelers on their 20-yard line. Just the sort of thing, of course, before a capacity crowd here at the stadium. Borman slips out to the left side. Buddy Dial flanked out to the right. Ed Brown is the quarterback. Brown calls signal, takes it, gives off to Ciron Sample, slips up the middle for 4 yards, a fumble, the Giants recover. Ciron Sample fumbled the ball, and the recovery was made by Jim Patton on the 24-yard line of the Steelers. Ciron Sample slipped as he went into the line, and as he hit the ground, the ball squirted loose, and it was recovered by Jim Patton. First and 10 on the 24-yard line of the Pittsburgh Steelers. Y.A. Tittle calling for quiet as the Giant offensive unit is on the field now. Giffen flanked to the right side. The rest of the ball club is tight. Tittle, call signals, goes straight back to pass on first down. And he's rushed and hit down for a loss back to the 31-yard line. He could not find a receiver. He looked, raised his hand, lowered his hand again, looked some more, and then he was hit down hard by Frank Atkinson and Lou Michaels. A loss back to the 31-yard line, a 7-yard loss, and a second and 17 for the Giants on the Steelers' 31-yard line. No score on the ball game. Al DeRogatis.
On this kind of a field, a frozen field, an initial pop is awfully important. If an offensive lineman don't get off real big, it could be trouble. We might watch for a screen here, Marty.
See where Frank Gifford is wearing sneakers. He's flanked wide out to the right side. Morrison and King are the deep back. The goes to King. King runs off his own right tackle. Cuts back, drives in front for 5 yards before he's pulled down at the 28-yard line. Bill King carrying. Joe Cooper and Mike Claudio combine to stop him. Ball placed down at the 28-yard line. It'll be 3rd and 14 on the Pittsburgh Steelers 28. No score in the football game. The Giants recovering a fumble by Ciron Sapp on the opening play on the Steelers 24-yard line. Up to the line of scrimmage come the New York Giants now. King and Morrison also wearing sneakers. Going back to pass is Tittle looking downfield. Throws angry to the left. It's incomplete. Through the hands of Dale Schaffner and incomplete as the angle to the left side at the 15-yard line. Dale Schaffner being defended against by Willie Daniel. Here's Don Chandler running on the field now to try a field goal. It's 4th and 14 for the Giants on the Pittsburgh Steelers 28-yard line. The kick will be about 35 yards. The angle is to the left. Kicking in towards the closed end of Yankee Stadium. The wind is not a factor now. A 34-yard attempt. The teams are lined up and set. Dripping will hold. The ball is snapped. Placed down. It's kicked by Chandler. High enough. Deep enough. And it is good. There's Herman on the field with a score. The Giants 3. The Steelers nothing. At Yankee Stadium before an enthused, excited crowd of 63,000. Don Chandler ready to kick off again for the Giants. Thomas and Bowman on the receivers. The kick is high and short. Coming down to about the 15-yard line, the second by Gary Foreman. He runs to his left, up to the 20-yard line. He has Parker in front of him. He's downfield, up to midfield, cutting back to his left, up to the 40-yard line of the Giants, down to the 30, and down he goes, at the 28-yard line of the Giants. Tackle made by Dick Pessinen. A beautiful run back by Gary Foreman, taking on his own 15-yard line, running it down the near sideline, past midfield, to the 28-yard line of the Giants. First and 10 for Pittsburgh on the Giants 28. Those run backs of kickoffs have plagued the Giants all year, and Bowman just ran one back into Giants territory to the Giants 28. Now Bowman is flanked wide to the right side. Buddy Dow split out to the left side. The deep backs are Stapp and Johnson. The handoff goes to Johnson up the middle for 2-3 yards. He keeps driving. Stealing is out for 4 yards before he stops. Down to the 24-yard line. Dick Modulewski pulled him down after he picked up 4. It'll be 2nd and 6 on the 24-yard line. Pittsburgh offensively has Theron Sapp and John Henry Johnson as the running back. Ed Brown is the quarterback, a 10-year veteran. Buddy Dial, the flanker back. The ends are Carpenter and Bowman. Carpenter the split end. Rather, Bowman the split end and Carpenter the tight end. Ed Brown looking over the Giant defense as his ball club is at the line of scrimmage. Takes a snap back. Hands up to John Henry Johnson, driving off right tackle. He stopped for no gain. No gain on the play. As Sam Huff, John Lovettier, and Eddie Robicelli come piling in to stop him for no gain. It'll be 3rd and 6 on the 24-yard line of the New York Giants. The score is Giants 3, Pittsburgh nothing. John Henry Johnson, last man to get to his feet. He was the ball carrier. Dick bruising 6'2", 215 pounds. Al DeRogatis.
Dick Lynch has been covering Buddy Dial here at the flanker in a man-on-man situation. Now the footing is pretty rugged. It looks as if Ed Brown might try to go with a down-and-out to Buddy Dial.
Eddie Brown takes the snapback, goes straight back to pass. It's 3rd and 6.
Throwing down the middle, and it's complete. A foot touch to Gary. No, he dropped it. He dropped it. He had it in his hand, and as he went to the ground, he dropped it. Incomplete.
Eric Barnes and Jim Patton defending on the play. A foot touch pattern about 10 yards downfield, and he dropped it as he went to the ground. He never had control. So it's 4th and 6 on the 24, and a field goal attempt coming up. Lou Michaels, a left-footed kicker, will try it. It'll be about 30 yards out. Let's see what they set up for it. It's going to be at the 29-yard line. No, 30-yard line it is. At the 30. The angle is to the right. The teams are lined up and set. Signals being called. The ball is snapped. Place down. Michael's kick. High enough, deep enough. It's no good. No good. It was wide to the right. And the Giants still lead 3-0. And it's Giants ball. As a result of the touchback, 1st and 10 on their 20-yard line. Neither team has been able to pick up a first down thus far. Both ball clubs warming up to this very difficult footing, getting accustomed to it. They haven't been able to move too well thus far, except for Gary Bowman's fine run back of the kickoff. Now Gifford flanks wide to the right. Schaffner split to the left side. King and Morrison to the deep back. Stittle call signals. And the handoff goes to King. King drives off his own right guard and goes for 4 yards, but a penalty marker is down as the Steelers might have been offside. Their offensive right tackle, Frank Atkinson, may have been in there. King picked up 5 yards on the play as the ball is placed down on the 25-yard line. And we're waiting for the decision by the officials and the New York Giants. Jack Stroud, offensive captain, elects to accept the penalty, so it'll be 1st and 5 on the 25-yard line. Pittsburgh was offside. It's 1st and 5 for the Giants. On the Giants' 25-yard line, the New York Giants are leading Pittsburgh 3-0. Gifford flanks wide out to the right side. Johnson split about 3 yards to the left. Tittle looking over the defense. Calling signals as he ducks in under the center. Takes the snapback. Hands up to King. He drives off right tackle. Straight down on the cliff for the moment. Goes forward for 4 yards. More action in a moment. The score, the Giants 3, Pittsburgh nothing.
Right now, you've got just enough time to pour yourself another Valentine. Do it. Get that Valentine smile of satisfaction. Enjoy that lively heads-up taste. There's nothing like it to liven up your living. Come on, everybody. Smile. Have a Valentine beer.
Second and 1 for the Giants on the New York Giants 29-yard line. Tittle takes the snapback. Gives up to Morrison. Morrison, front of the ball. It's loose. Running free.
And let's see what the recovery is. Pittsburgh ball. Pittsburgh recovered as Clendon Thomas fell on the ball. Joe Morrison fumbled, and Clendon Thomas recovered for Pittsburgh on the Giants' 33-yard line. So it's Pittsburgh ball, first and 10, on the Giants' 33 with the Giants leading 3-0. Al DeRogatis.
Defensively, both teams have been using an extremely tight 4-3 or 4-4. The idea is to close off the middle, figuring that neither team can really run well to the outside because of the footing.
Footy down, flanks wide to the right side. Ed Brown goes back to pass on first down, looking downfield, being run. He throws, it's loose, and it's, let's see what the recovery is going to be. It's still Pittsburgh ball for a loss. Back on the 38-yard line. As Ed Brown was looking to throw, John Levitier, Andy Robustelli, and Dick Modulescu were in on him. Someone deflected his hand, the ball rolled free, and it was recovered by Mike Sandusky, a guard of the Pittsburgh Steelers, on the 38-yard line, a 5-yard loss. It's 2nd and 15 now for the Pittsburgh Steelers on the Giants' 38-yard line. The Giants leading 3-0. 5 minutes are gone in this first quarter. Buddy Dial flanks wide out to the right side. The rest of the ball club is tight. Ed Brown calls the signal, takes the snapback, hands off now to Staff. Staff slips as he cuts up field, drives to 3-4 yards, and down he goes. He ran to his right, ran off his own right tackle, flipped as he cut up field, and he was pulled down by Dick Modulescu, John Levitier, and Sam Huff. Ball placed down on the 33-yard line. 5-yard gain. It's 3rd and 10 on the 33 of the New York Giants. Pittsburgh Steelers in possession. The Giants leading 3-0. Dial again, flanked to the right side. Foreman split out to the left. Brown, the quarterback, goes straight back to pass on 3rd and long yardage. Throws angle to the left side. It's complete now. The 6, the 15-yard line. Running with the ball to Foreman down to the 5, to the goal line. A fumble, a loose ball, the Giants recover. Eric Jones is running it out along the near side to the 20-yard line. The 25, up the left side. He has running room. Running along the 30-yard line, and he's forced out of bounds at the 32. A remarkable play. Gary Foreman hit, fumbled at the goal line. Picked up in the end zone by Eric Bond, and Bond ran it out. Up along the near sideline, then cutting to his left, along the 30-yard line, and ran out of bounds on the far side at about the 34. Giants ball, 1st and 10, in this wild first quarter. Giants come through the line of scrimmage. Y.A. Tittle calling for quiet. Gets it flank right, drops a split left, and now there's an official's timeout for just a moment, as Y.A. Tittle cannot be heard by his Giants teammates. A fantastic play. They'll be talking about that one for a long time. As Eric Barnes picked up the fumble in the end zone and ran it out. He could have stayed in there for a touchback, but he ran it out. And he ran it out to the 34-yard line. Now, quiet results, and the handoff goes to Joe Morrison running off his own left guard. He pulled down for a loss. As he tried his own left guard, he up for a 2-yard loss back to the 32-yard line, where it'll be 2nd and 12 on the 32. Joe Morrison carrying. And it would seem to me, Al, that the ball carriers particularly are having extreme difficulty, not only with their footing, but handling that cold football too.
They really are, Marty. And perhaps the men that are having a tougher time are the men up front trying to get off a good block.
2nd and 12 on the 32, the Giants leading. And the handoff goes to Phil King. He busts up the middle, drives up field. It's a 12-yard. Up to the 43-yard line, 44-yard line. Good for a first down for the Giants. Mighty close to it, at least, and they're going to measure. It was 2nd and 12. He picked up about 12 yards on that run, and the off-sticks ought to be brought out. Al DeRogatis?
The Steelers have so far shown 3 different defenses. They've shown an odd man line whereby they put the right tackle head-on the center. And that will leave number 70, Ernie Stauner, playing the weak side pretty much alone, and Ernie made a big play on that. Then they have switched on a second down situation, and they've come with a 4-4, again, with the 2 linebackers playing outside the 2 interior tackles, figuring that they're going to close off this middle very definitely, and then the defense they go with most of the time is pretty much their straight 4-3 defense.
It was shy of a first down by about 3 inches. It'll be 3rd and inches. The ball is on the 43-yard line. Series began back on the 34, the Giants. 3rd and inches.
And Joe Walton has come in replacing Dale Schaffner at split end. He probably will play a tight end now as the drafts go for the yardage. Third and inches on the 43. Gibbons blank to the right side. The rest of the ball club is tight. Siddle, call signal, takes the snapback, gives to Morrison. Morrison, no! A quick pass up the middle. It's complete to Thomas. Thomas up to the 40-yard line of the Steelers. A beautiful fake by Y.A. Siddle. He faked the handoff to Morrison, stepped back, and threw over the middle of Aaron Thomas. Thomas was pulled down on the Steelers' 41-yard line. A fantastic gamble taken by the Giants. They had 3rd and inches in their own territory, and they threw for the first down to the Steelers' 41-yard line. 1st and 10 on the 41 of the Steelers. And Dale Schaffner comes back in, replacing Joe Walton. And the ends are Aaron Thomas and Dale Schaffner. Walton comes to the side. Gibbons back to the right side. King and Morrison are the deep back. 1st and 10 on the Steelers' 41. Siddle goes back to pass, throws deep down to the left side to Schaffner. Way down! Touchdown!
Giants leading 9-0, 7.5 minutes.
to go in the first quarter. Handoff goes to Pierre Rapsat. He goes off his own left guard, drives for 1 or 2 yards, and he's held upright and then topples over as 3-4 of the Giants bring him to the ground. Pierre Rapsat, the ball carrier. Ball placed down at about the 38-yard line. He picked up 2 yards on the play. It'll be 2nd and 3 on the 38-yard line of the Pittsburgh Steelers. The New York Giants are out in front by a score of 9-0. We'll pause for station identification. This is the Giants Football Network.
WGY, the General Electric Station in Schenectady.
Ed Brown, the quarterback, hands up to John Henry Johnson, who pulls up the middle, goes for 10, 12 yards before he's pulled down. Past midfield to the 48-yard line of the Giants. Big John Henry Johnson pulling up the middle on a straight power play before he was stopped by Jim Patton, Sam Huff, and Dick Pessinen. So it's 1st and 10 now for the Pittsburgh Steelers. The ball is on the 48-yard line of the Giants. The Giants are out in front by a score of 9-0. Fantastic first quarter thus far. Now the Steelers in their white uniforms and black and gold trim go to the line of scrimmage. Flankers are right and left. Brown takes it, goes straight back to pass on first down. Good protection. Throws deep, deep down the middle. Intercepted by Dupree. Looks at the 10-yard line. Looks for blocking. He has plenty of room. Up to the 20-yard line. Now to the right side of the 30-yard line. Up to the 40. Still has blocking. And he goes out of bounds at the 44. Dupree, leading the league in interception. Runs out of bounds at the 44 for the Giants. The intended receiver on the play was Buddy Dial.
Aldi Regardis. Marty, just to show you how adept the Giants are defensively. Now, Jimmy Patton, as soon as the interception was made, knew he had one block, and that was to go for Buddy Dial. But coming upfield, the guy that's the all-pro defensive end, Jim Cavett, put on a real big block to shake Dick Lewis for a few more yards.
1st and 10 for the Giants on their 44-yard line. Going back to pass is Temple. He's rushed. He's over the ball. It's loose. Rolling free. And let's see who recovers. It may be the Giants recover. They did. The Giants did recover. Tittle, rolling out to his right, was hit as he went back. The ball popped free. Andy Russell, the man who hit him, as he shot the gap. Recovery made by Greg Lawson on the play, back on the 30-yard line. It's a 14-yard loss. So it'll be 2nd and 24 for the Giants on the Giants' 30-yard line. Red dogging on the play was Russell, who came charging in, and as Tittle turned, he was hit. The ball popped away. Well, it's 2nd and 24 on the Giants' 30. That ball is tough to handle today. Tittle takes it. Goes back to pass. Now he has protection. Throws out to the right side. Complete to Morrison. Morrison back up the line of scrimmage. Runs along the near sideline. Up to the 30 again, and that's it. More action in the moment. The score, the Giants 9, the Steelers nothing.
This is Jack Benny. I'd like to ask you to remember that holiday time means Christmas seal time. Christmas seals on all our holiday mail to fight tuberculosis. Make sure there are Christmas seals on every card, on every package, to help protect everyone from TB. Thank you.
It's 3rd and 24 for the New York Giants on the Giants' 30-yard line. Giants are leading by a score of 9-0. Tittle going back to pass, slipping as he does, looks downfield, throws angling deep down on the left side to Schoster. He's got it, and he's got it inbound, and a good ball, the first down. A beautiful play up to the 46-yard line of the Steelers. A marvelous play by Y.A. Tittle and Dell Schoster. A down-and-out pattern, but just at the sideline, just far enough for the first down by a foot. How's that for precision? Howdy, Regardis.
That was great for precision, Marty, but I'm sure no one envies the defensive halfbacks. It's an awfully tough job to try to cover anyone on this kind of a field. The offensive band does have the big advantage.
Well, 5 minutes and 15 seconds remain in this first quarter, and time has been called on the field. There'll be more action in a moment. The score of the New York Giants 9, the Pittsburgh Steelers nothing.
Here's a gift suggestion for the men on your Christmas list. Famous Milder White Owl cigars come beautifully gift-wrapped. There's an attractive range of prices, too. Just $1.68 to $4.75. Give White Owl at food, drug, and tobacco stores.
Yeah.
Yankee Stadium, a tremendously excited crowd watching the New York Giants lead the Pittsburgh Steelers by a score of 9-0. At Chicago, in the first period, the Chicago Bears lead the Detroit Lions 3-0. Al DeRogatis.
Marty, watching number 79, the left end for the Pittsburgh Steelers, Lou Michaels. He's a good boy and makes a real good outside charge. And I think Y.A. Tittle will probably try to trap him and hit to the inside of Michaels.
Well, it's first and 10 on the Pittsburgh 46. Giants have the ball. Tittle calls the signals. Hands off to Morrison. Morrison drives up to the line of scrimmage, picks up 3-4 yards before he stops. Goes down to about the 41-yard line, all the 42, and he stopped at the right side by Mike Patios, the middle linebacker. That ball placed down at the 42-yard line. He picked up 4. It'll be 2nd and 6 for the Giants on the 42 of the Pittsburgh Steelers. New York Giants scored on a field goal by Don Chandler of 34 yards and a 41-yard touchdown pass from Tittle to Schaffner. For Tittle, his 3-4th touchdown pass of the year, and he has thus set a new record for touchdown passes in one season. The old mark was 33, held by Tittle. Giants are at the line of scrimmage now. Tittle takes it, hands up to King. King goes up the middle, flicks away. He's going to fly 6-7 yards, and then he's filled by Clinton Thomas. Good for another first down. Down to the 32, 33-yard line of the Pittsburgh Steelers. Again, that trap play up the middle, and Bill King is running exceptionally well thus far today. He's really busting up in there. Ball is placed down at the 33-yard line. He picked up 9 on the play. First and 10 for the Giants on the Pittsburgh Steelers 33-yard line. Giants are leading by a score of 9-0 with 4 minutes and 10 seconds remaining in this first quarter. Frank Evans, Mike to the right side. The rest of the ball club is tight. King and Morrison all the deep backs. Tittle takes the snapback, goes straight back to pass. Good protection. Throws, I'm to the right side. Completes it, Thomas at the 20, and down he goes to the 16-yard line. Another first down for the Giants. Aaron Thomas pulled down on the play by Dick Haley at the 16-yard line. First and 10 for the Giants. On the Pittsburgh Steelers, 16. The New York Giants are out in front, 9-0. Al DeRogatis.
Willie Daniels, number 44, playing the right corner halfback for the Steelers, is moving right up to the line of scrimmage. This is awfully dangerous when you're playing against a guy like Del Schaffner.
First and 10 for New York on the Steelers, 16. Flankers are right and left. Going back to pass to Tittle on first down. Being rushed, throws the screen out to the left. It's complete to Morrison. He has plenty of room. He's down to 10. He slips and gets out of the 8-yard line. He slipped as he started to cut back. Remember, the Giants are going in towards the close end of the stadium. It's extremely hard there, the turf is. Frozen. He slipped at the 8-yard line, and the play picked up 8 yards, so a 2nd and 2 on the 8. Had he not slipped, he might have gone all the way. He had blockers around him, also Steelers around him, but he was still on his feet until he slipped. Bob Schmitz was the man who pinned him down, but it was the slip that counted. 2nd and 2 on the 8 of the Pittsburgh Steelers. The New York Giants leading 9-0. Giffen flanks wide out to the right side. Tittle looking over that defense as he ducks in under the center. Calls the signal. Takes the snapback. Hands off to King. King goes up the middle. Goes for the first down to the 5. First and goal to go on the 5-yard line. Big pile up at the 5-yard line. Let's see where this... They're going to measure once again. And it looks as though it's clearly a first down, and some of the crowd is dissatisfied as the ball, the nose of the ball seems to be resting on the 5-yard line. And the yardsticks are being brought out. The yardsticks were short of the 5-yard line, or so it seemed. At any rate, the Giants lead 9-0. The yardsticks are out there now. Jack Stroud and Y.A. Tittle, along with the officials and all of the Steelers, looking at it. It is the first down. So it's first and goal to go on the 5. Yes, Al?
On that last play, Marty, the right side of the Giant offensive line really did a fine job. Jack Stroud really moved across there to Lou Michaels and really put a good block on him, as did Bookie Ball on Joe Krupa. And the center, Greg Larson, shoots straight ahead to the middle linebacker, Myron Patios.
First and goal to go on the 5-yard line. The Pittsburgh Steelers are packed in tight. It's an 8-3 defense. Tittle calls the play. Man in motion is Giffen. A pitch out to Giffen, circling around the left side. He's looking to pass. He stops. He runs back to his right. He's being trapped back there. He laterals back to Lawson. Lawson is pulled out of the tenure. No, another lateral goes to Giffen again. He throws into the end zone. Incomplete. What a play, and a penalty marker as well. They were playing basketball with it, literally. Giffen came in motion. Took a handoff, swinging to his left from Y.A. Tittle. Was trapped back there.
Lateral back to Greg Lawson. Lawson ran. Lateral to Tittle. Tittle back to Giffen. Giffen threw a pass to Thomas. Incomplete. Penalty marker. Oh, boy.
And a penalty is against the Giants, a 15-yarder. Well, it was first and goal to go on the 5. Now it'll be first and goal on the 20-yard line. Fantastic first quarter. A minute and 54 seconds remain in this first period. The Giants lead 9-0. Yes, Al?
Well, you know, the Pittsburgh Steelers will probably figure the Giants for the pass. They're going to be putting on a real big rush. We might look for Y.A. Tittle to come with a fake dive and then come with a draw, giving it to the second man. The idea of the fake dive is to pull the linebacker over.
First and goal to go on the Steelers' 20-yard line. Y.A. Tittle call signals, takes the snapback, rolls out to his right to pass. Good blocking back there. Throws out to the right side and is intercepted by the Steelers on the 2-yard line and pulled down at the 5-yard line is Andy Russell. A high arcing pass in tennis of Frank Gibbons, intercepted, and is first and 10 for the Pittsburgh Steelers on their 6-yard line is where it's placed down. The Giants still leading 9-0. So the Pittsburgh offensive unit comes in there now, a Giants defensive unit, which you know so well, on the field for the Steelers. Stapp and Johnson, the D-backs, Ed Brown, the quarterback, Buddy Dial, the flanker back. The ends are Carpenter, the tight end, and Borman, the split end. The tackles, James and Bradshaw. The guards, Sandusky and Lemick. The center is Nutter, Buzz Nutter. First and 10 on their own 6-yard line. The handoff goes to Stapp. He sets to the line of scrimmage. No gain, maybe a yard. More action at the moment. The score, the Giants 9, the Steelers nothing. Line of the Steelers. And the handoff goes to Stapp again. Again, Stapp stopped at the line of scrimmage. Maybe a yard on the play. Sam Huff and Dick Modulewski stopping them there. And now the New York Giants defensive unit seems to be contending that offensive club of the Steelers well on the ground. Al DeRogatis.
The Giants defense, Marty, they're moving up and playing it extremely tight right in the middle. Now, Jimmy Patton playing the weak side safety is moving up to the line of scrimmage, making it virtually a 4-4 or an 8, depending on how hard it charges the middle linebacker or the linebacker's good.
Now it's 3rd and 9 on the 7-yard line of the Steelers. And the handoff goes to Big John Henry Johnson for 2 yards, 3 yards, and he stopped. And now the Pittsburgh Steelers are forced to punt. He picked up 3 yards up to the 10-yard line. So it'll be 4th and 6 on the Steelers' 10. And the Pittsburgh Steelers are forced to punt. John Lovett here and Tom Scott came in to stop them. The quarter will end, and that's the gun. That's the end of the first quarter with a score of the Giants 9, the Pittsburgh Steelers nothing. Well, here at Yankee Stadium, they're talking about their first quarter of play, and they will be talking about it for months and perhaps years to come. The Giants out in front, 9-0. Ed Brown, the quarterback, is also the punter for the Pittsburgh Steelers. The 10-year veteran is 6 yards in his own end zone. Twin safety for the Giants are Dove and Pessinen, waiting for the snap from center. It comes back to Brown. Brown moves forward and boots that ball. Just does get in the way. A good kick. Out to the Giants' 45-yard line, taken there by Pessinen. He moves upfield for 8 yards, and down he goes in Steelers territory at the Steelers' 47-yard line. Buzz Nutter, the center, led the defensive charge. So it's 1st and 10 for the Giants in Steelers territory on the Pittsburgh 47-yard line. Giants out in front, 9-0. Giants scoring on the field goal of 34 yards by Don Chandler and a 41-yard touchdown pass, Tittle the shotgun. 1st and 10 for New York on Pittsburgh's 47. Y.A. Tittle calls the signals. Takes the snapback. Hands off to King, swinging wide to his left. Makes the turn upfield, and he pulls out, picking up 1 yard on the play at the 46-yard line. Willie Daniel came up fast from his right corner position to make the tackle. A good one on Phil King. It's 2nd and 9 on the 46. Phil King carrying the ball. In the second quarter at Chicago, the Bears still lead the Detroit Lions 3-0. In other games in the second period, Baltimore 10, Los Angeles nothing. Minnesota 13, Philadelphia 6 in the third quarter. 2nd and 9 on the 46. Gifford flanked to the right side of Tittle. Goes back to pass, looks downfield, throws down the middle, incomplete through the hands of Del Schofter. A front knock about 15 yards downfield. Schofter racing downfield, spinning around and stopping. The pass went through his hands, high over his head, incomplete. Willie Daniel defending. So it's 3rd and 9 on the 46. All the Pittsburgh Steelers, the New York Giants ahead 9-0 in the opening minute of the second quarter of play. The Giants now moving towards the open end of Yankee Stadium. Giants in their home uniforms are blue with white and red trim. Pittsburgh Steelers in white with black and gold trim. New York Giants still huddled up. Y.A. Tittle breaks the huddle now. Gifford runs out to the right side of the flanker. Sharpness flips to the left side. They're running back to King and Morrison. Tittle calls the signals. Takes the snap back. Goes straight back to pass. Stepped over the pocket. Throws. It's complete to Gifford. A penalty marker is thrown down. A penalty marker is down, and it may be the play will be nullified. Let's see what the ball is going to be. It's mighty close to a first down. And they're pointing, gesticulating. And the ball is being brought back. And a 15-yarder is being marked off against the Giants for offensive holding, I believe. It is back to the 28-yard line. A 15-yarder it is. We're waiting for the signal from referee Norman Schachter. Still waiting for the signal. Now let's see what the call is now. We still don't get a signal. We know the ball is back to the 28-yard line. No signal from the official. Obviously, offensive holding. Al DeRogatis. Willie Daniels, number 44, and Glendon Thomas, number 28, are double covering Del Schachter here on the left side. And it would look as if Y.A. Tittle's man will have to be Aaron Thomas. So we might keep our eye on Aaron. Third and very long yardage for the Giants. The ball is on their 28-yard line. Tittle on a draw play to Joe Morrison looking for running room. He stumbles, runs out to the right, and he's thrown back there for a loss. Back to the 24-yard line. A 4-yard loss on the play. And now the Giants punting unit comes on the field. New York Giants in front of Pittsburgh by a score of 9-0. 13 minutes and 18 seconds remain in this first half. Don Chandler punting out towards left center field. Twin safeties for the Pittsburgh Steelers are Clendon Thomas and Dick Haley. They're back around their own 30-yard line. Chandler standing on his own 10. He gets the snap from center, moves forward, and boots that ball. A pretty kick. A perfect spiral deep. Going out of the 25-yard line, taken out by Dick Haley. He runs to his left, and he's thrown under by three of the Giants. Pulling him down, Lane Howell leading the defensive charge. Back at about the 32-yard line. 30-yard line it is. More action in a moment. The score, the Giants 9, the Steelers nothing.
Don't let an irritating cough or sore throat spoil the holidays ahead. Get soothing comfort from HB, hospital brand cough drops, the Happy Holiday cough drops. A favorite for over 50 years, HB cough drops are medicated for fast, sure relief. Look for them in the clean white HB box at your nearest drug or candy counter. Get HB, hospital brand, the Happy Holiday cough drops.
For 2 yards on the play, more than that, 4 yards on the play, up to the 34-yard line. As he drove up the middle, stopped finally by Jim Patton and Dick Kessinen. Second and six on the 34 as the Pittsburgh Steelers go to the line of scrimmage. Buddy Dyer flanked out to the right side. Gary Bowman split to the left. The running backs are Johnson and Sapp. And the handoff goes to Johnson. Johnson up the middle, stopped to the line of scrimmage. No gain. Maybe a yard or two as the big pileup develops. Falling forward for 2 yards up to the 36-yard line. It'll be third and four on the 36. New York Giants out in front by a score of 9-0. Substitution, Johnny Powers comes into the lineup, replacing Gary Bowman at end for the Pittsburgh Steelers. Third and four on the 36 of the Pittsburgh Steelers. Big play coming up for both four clubs as the Giants lead 9-0. 4 minutes are gone in this second quarter. Line of the Steelers. The ball is resting on the 40-yard line. It should be a first down. Josh Fisher out there now. And the Giants around it. It is a first down. First and 10 for Pittsburgh on the Pittsburgh 40-yard line. How do you regard it?
Up to this point, the Steelers haven't gambled at all. They're figuring strictly ball control, keeping that football on the ground. Now, that last play, the Giants had virtually the entire squad up to the line of scrimmage, but still, he hit right up in there, and he did make the first.
First and 10 on the 40. Brown ducks in under the center, takes the snap back, hands up to Steele on snap, trying to pickle his own left end. He's trying to make the stand up field. He picks up 4 or 5 yards, and down he goes, picking up 5 yards on the play, up to the 45. Trying to pickle his own left end. Dick Fessenden coming up strong. to make that tackle. Ball placed out at the 46-yard line. It'll be second and four on the 46 of the Pittsburgh Steelers. Advance it up in front, 9-0. For Pittsburgh, their running backs are Fearon Sapp and John Henry Johnson. Sapp, a five-year veteran out of Georgia, 6'1 and 200 pounds. And John Henry Johnson, who's 6'2 and 215 out of Arizona State. Second and four around the 46. Buddy Dyer flanked out to the right side of the handoff to John Henry Johnson up the middle. He stuffed for no gain. Big pile up, no gain. Jim Patton coming in to help out with John Leverteer. They give him 1 yard on him. Let's see what the call is. Finally, one of the Steelers saying something to one of the Giants and pointing at each other, and the crowd is picking up the signs and gesticulations of the two ball clubs. 1 yard gain on the play. Aldi Regardis.
The strategy on the play was pretty good, Marty. Gary Baldwin was extending, or at least trying to put on a fake block. He didn't do a very good job of it. The Giants were able to come over and cover.
Ed Brown dropping back to his own 32-yard line. Ball the snap from center. Twin safety for the Giants. There's the kick. A low, twisting spiral coming down to the 20-yard line. Taken there by Eddie Dove. He goes up the middle for 5-6 yards. A fumble, a loose ball. Let's see what the recovery is. Pittsburgh. The score, the Giants 9, Pittsburgh 0.
Young lady, every college graduate should become familiar with the opportunity for patriotic service offered by the Navy Wave Officer Program. To serve your country proudly as women officers in the United States Navy, see your recruiter today and learn all about service in the United States Navy.
Stand for the Pittsburgh Steelers on the Giants 24-yard line. Buzz Nutter made the recovery of the fumble. Dyer flanked to the right side. The handoff goes to Fearon Sapp. Sapp stopped at the line of scrimmage, drive forward for 1 yard before Dick Mondolefsky comes busting through to lead the defensive charge. Jerry Hillebrand in on the play along with Andy Robicelli, but Dick Mondolefsky down at the bottom of the pile. It's second and nine on the 23-yard line of the Giants. The Giants are out in front by a score of 9-0. The Pittsburgh Steelers driving in towards the closed end of Yankee Stadium. The entire field is now in shadow. Though it may be breezy in your neighborhood right now, down on the well of the stadium, the wind is no factor as of this moment. Ed Brown takes it, goes back to pass on second down, throws down the middle. It completes the ball at the 15-yard line, and he's pulled down to the 15 by Jim Patton. Ball placed down at the 14-yard line, and it's mighty close to a first down, and they measure for this one again. Mighty close to a first down. It'll be third and inches or first and 10 on the 14. It's third and inches. Third and inches on the 14-yard line. The play began on the 24-yard line, or the series began on the 24. So it's third and inches on the 14 of the Giants. Powell comes in to the end, replacing Gary Bowman. The Giants are leading 9-0. 7 minutes are gone in the second quarter. Ed Brown, the quarterback. Takes the snapback, gives to John Henry Johnson. He made a big stop. He fell forward at the line of scrimmage. He went up the middle. See Jim Cavett, John Leverteer, Dick Mondolefsky. And let's see where that ball is going to be placed down. It's short of the 14-yard line, so it's fourth and one. Fourth and about 2 feet. Fourth and 2 feet at the 14. It looks as though the Steelers are going to go for it. The Steelers have not sent in, or they have Michael on the sideline. He's not in yet. And they're going to go for it. Fourth and 2 feet on the Giants 14. Ed Brown, the quarterback, takes the snap back. Gives the snap. Stop it. He fell forward. It's very close. It's very close. A big pileup. He went off his own left guard. Official's timeout. The big pileup stopped at the 15 and fell to about the 14. It looks as though it's short. They're going to measure, but it looks as though it's short. The ball is still shy of the 14-yard line. The yardsticks ought to be brought out, but it looks as though it's shy. The yardsticks are being brought out. What a football game this is. And it is short. Giant ball.
A magnificent stand by the Giants defensive unit. Three attempts at the line, and they failed to make 1 foot. DeRogatis, you're right, Marty. Defensively, the Giants did a real great job. The unfortunate thing for anybody carrying the ball, however, it's impossible to make that cut to the outside. It might have been a little open for Theron.
First and 10 on the 14-yard line of the Giants. The Giants in possession. The handoff goes to Phil King. He fluffs up his online tackle for 2 yards up to the 16-yard line where he stopped. It'll be second and 8 on the 16. New York Giants offensively with Del Shostner and Aaron Thomas at the ends. Rosie Brown and Jack Stroud are the tackles. Darrell Dess and Bookie Baldwin, the guards. Greg Lawson is the center. And Lane Howell is up off the bench. He'd come in for Jack Stroud if he goes in. The backs are King and Morrison, the running backs. Webster is ready, but he's not played yet. Gifford is the flanker back. And Yelberton, Abraham Kittle, the quarterback. Schaffner split out to the left side. Second and 8 on the Giants' 16-yard line. The Giants leading 9-0. Tittle calls the play. Goes back to pass.
Throws the ball, and it's incomplete. He started the throw, and as he threw his rear foot that he planted back there, slipped. He was looking for Dale Schaffner, and the ball actually was thrown down at his own feet. At Schaffner's feet, or rather at Tittle's feet. He slipped as he threw the ball. And the ball sort of spun crazily out of his hands at Tittle's feet. And it's ruled incomplete. Jack Stroud comes out of the lineup, and Lane Howell comes in. Lane Howell comes in to play tackle. It's third and 8 on the 16-yard line. Schaffner split wide out to the left side. The Giants leading 9-0. 6:15 to go in this first half. Tittle may be calling an automatic. Ducks it under the center. Takes the snap back. Hands off to Morrison. Morrison busts out to the right. Goes for 4 yards and he stops. More action in the moment. The score, the Giants 9, the Steelers nothing.
The men on your Christmas list will like your idea of White Owl cigars. You'll find them at your local drug, food, and tobacco stores in beautiful Christmas packaging. And with a wide range of prices, $1.68 to $4.75. Give White Owl, and you'll make any man's Christmas a merry one.
It's 4th and 6 on the 18-yard line. Don Chandler is in his punt formation. He's waiting on his own 4-yard line. Gets the snap from center and boots that ball. A high floater, not too deep. Coming down in midfield, bounding down towards the 40-yard line. Picked up by Clinton Thomas. He slips as he picks the ball up. And down he goes, and he's pinned down by 2 of the Giants. Lane Howell in on the tackle, along with Mickey Walker. The Giants are leading 9-0. 5.5 minutes remain in this first half. It's 1st and 10 for the Pittsburgh Steelers, and the ball is down on the 38-yard line of the Steelers. Al DeRogatis.
The Giants figuring if the Steelers are running on a 1st and 10 situation, are generally moving Jimmy Pratt, who generally makes the decision, right at the line of scrimmage in a 4-4. Eddie Brown may try shortly to change his strategy and go to the air.
Eddie Brown now goes back to pass on 1st down. He's being rushed, looks out to the left, throws over the middle, and is caught by Buddy Dial at the midfield line. He runs to his left along the 50-yard line, and down he goes at the 50. Eddie Brown was rushed very hard on the play, but he sidestepped tacklers, and he was finally got rid of that ball up the middle to Buddy Dial to the midfield line. It's good for 12 yards and a 1st down. There's a near altercation on the field amongst the Steelers and Giants. And they're talking with Buzz Nutter, the offensive center of the Pittsburgh Steelers. Now let's see what the ruling is going to be. We're getting no signal from the officials. The ball is down on the 49-yard line of the Steelers. It's set for a 1st down. A penalty refused by the Steelers. Defensive holding. So it's 1st and 10 for the Pittsburgh Steelers on the 49-yard line of the Steelers. The Giants are out in front by a score of 9-0. 5 minutes remain in this 1st half. Buddy Dial flanked wide out to the right side. Gary Bowman split to the left side. And the handoff goes to snap up to the middle of the line, and he stopped. No gain. Maybe a yard loss on the play. A try in the middle of the Giant line, but that Giant line is holding solidly in the middle with Sam Huff, John Lovitz here, Dick Modulewski, along with Tom Scott, all in on that last play.
No gain. Second and 10 on the 49. Yes, Al? We'll more than likely now see the Giants go into what they like to call a Sam 1, a weak side safety and Sam Huff moving up to the line of scrimmage and trying to put as much pressure as possible. This means the middle could be open, and we might watch for Gary Bowman.
Well, it's second and 10 on the 49 as Brown looks over the Giant defense, and the Giant defense moves, goes into the line. John Henry Johnson takes it, goes up the middle, picks up 4, 5, 6 yards on the play before he stops. As he picks up 6 right down to the Giants' 45-yard line, to the Giants' 44 is where it's placed now. 7-yard gain is 3rd and 3 on the 44. Big John Henry Johnson going inside his own left tackle. So another big play in this ball game. 3rd and 3 on the Giants. 44-yard line. The Giants leading 9-0. 4 minutes to go in this first half. Buddy Dial flanked again wide out to the right side. Rest of the ball club is tight. Giant defense is packed in solid 2. Brown takes it. Hands off now to Stapp, trying to go wide. Cuts back inside. He makes it 4 or 5 yards. Good for the first down. He's down to the Giants' 37-yard line. He picks up 7 yards on the play where Jim Patton and Dick Pessinen made the tackle. So it's 1st and 10 for the Steelers. On the Giants' 37-yard line, the New York Giants leading 9-0. 3.5 minutes to go in this first half, and time may become a factor in the course of this grinding, grueling drive of the Pittsburgh Steelers. Moving along the ground most of the way, trying to go inside the tackles. And now the Giants have called for a timeout. So there's timeout on the field with a score of the New York Giants 9, the Pittsburgh Steelers nothing.
Every time you taste a cold Valentine, you get that smile of satisfaction. You're refreshed because Valentine's lively heads-up taste keeps satisfying beer after beer. Come on, everybody, smile. Have a Valentine beer.
At Yankee Stadium in New York City, Marty Glickman reporting along with Al DeRogatis and Joe Hassel. With 3 minutes and 23 seconds remaining in this first half, the Steelers have the ball, 1st and 10 on the Giants, 37. The Giants have the lead, 9-0. John Henry Johnson running into the huddle now. He was talking to Coach Buddy Walker on the far sideline. Buddy Parker, rather. Up to the line of scrimmage now come the Steelers. Buddy Dow splits to the right side. Foreman flanks to the left side. Going back to pass to Zip Brown on first down with plenty of time back there. He throws deep into the end zone. Incomplete. Intended to Gary Foreman, incomplete at the goal line. We'll pause now for station identification. This is the Giants Football Network.
Your dial is set at 810, the smoothest sound around. WGY is connected. Our temperature is 17 degrees.
That was one of a few times in the ballgame that Ed Brown had plenty of time to throw, but he overthrew Gary Foreman. Yes, Al?
Now, the Giants had a bit of an outside rush, Marty. If there's one guy in the National Football League that can really run the draw, it's John Henry Johnson. So it's going to be interesting to see how Sam Huff should play him if this should develop.
Second and 10 on the 37. And there's a handoff to John Henry up the middle. He played it most interestingly. A 1 yard loss on the play to the 38-yard line. Sam Huff driving in along with Tom Scott. Scott leading the defensive charge. No gain on the play, not a 1 yard loss, but at the line of scrimmage, John Henry was met solidly by Tom Scott and Sam Huff. Theron Stapp runs to the sideline, and Dick Hope replaces him in the lineup in the backfield. It'll be 3rd and 10 on the 37-yard line of the Steelers. It's a shotgun formation, flankers all left and right. Ed Brown, 8 yards back of the center. Gets the snap from center, goes back to pass, throws right down the middle, and it's dropped by Jimmy Patton. He had it in his hands at the 20-yard line. He fumbled the ball and dropped it, and Jimmy is unhappy about it.
So it's fourth and 10 on the 37. That was a shotgun formation, flankers and split ends. A passing formation, and the pass was thrown downfield intended for Gary Bowman, but Jim Patton almost intercepted. He knocked it down, and it's fourth and 10 on the 37. Here's a long field goal attempt coming up. A 42-yarder. 43 yards. The angle is to the left. Jimmy Patton is the only man back there. The ball is snapped, placed down, and fumble. It's loose, rolling around, and Giants recover. Giants have the ball on the 43-yard line, and it's first and 10 for New York. The ball was fumbled. Fumbled by Bill Nelson, who was trying to hold. And Sam Huff and John Lovettier came barreling through, and it's first and 10 for the Giants on the Giants 42. 2 minutes and 28 seconds remain in the first half. The Giants are out in front by a score of 9-0. Skip is flanked wide to the right side. Dale Sharp the split to the left side. Running back to Morrison and King. Siddle calls the play. Takes it. Goes back to pass. Makes short. Throws deep. Deep down to the left side. To Sharp. He's got it at the 15. He's down at the 12. A beauty to Dale Sharp. Going to Dale Schaffner at the 13-yard line is where it's placed down. The tackle by Willie Daniel. Aldi Regardis. The beauty of the play, Marty, happened. A great catch, actually, by Dale. A wonderful pass by Y.A. Tittle. But there was a fake draw into the line. That meant that Glendon Thomas, who was playing the weak side safety, couldn't peel off on Dale Schaffner late. And as long as that draw held him, Dale Schaffner was able to complete that down fly pattern with a look in.
Dale Sharp has come to the sideline, and he's being helped to the sideline. He may have hurt his hand or shoulder. And he's sitting on the bench on the near side. Joe Walton has replaced him in the lineup, which means that Walton will play the tight end, and Aaron Thomas will play the split end. But Dale Schaffner was way out in the clear again. The pass actually was a little bit underthrown. He had to wait for it. It was a little wobbly, unusual for YA. And the play covered 45 yards. And now it's first and 10 for the Giants on the Pittsburgh Steelers 13-yard line. 2 minutes remain in the first half. The Giants are out in front 9-0. And the New York Giants, with time taken, are huddled up around YA Tittle. Joe Walton, Johnny in the huddle. And Y.A. Tittle most anxious to get that ball club underway again, looking out towards the official, holding that clock. And the whistle should sound in just a moment. Yes, Al?
The Giant offensive line, Marty, are really doing a fine job now blocking. They're showing real good balance and making a good initial cut. Now, here's a situation where Y.A. Tittle likes to come with that cross that we were talking about last week. However, I'm sure the Steelers know that they do like this, and we might watch Y.A. come with the cross pattern, but possibly swing Joe Morrison to the right, so to Joe.
Now play about to be resumed. First and 10 on the 13. Y.A. Tittle looking right and left. Takes the snap back. A draw play to Joe Morrison. He goes up the middle, trying to swing wide now. Goes down to the 10-yard line to the 8-yard line. Right down to the 8-yard line. Joe Morrison carrying for 5 yards. It's second and 5 on the 8-yard line of the Pittsburgh Steelers. The clock is running. 1:45 to go in this first half. Patios and Daniel combine to make the tackle, and the Giants hustle back into their huddle. A draw play up the middle and angling out to the left side. Clock is running, 1:30 to go in the first half. Second and 5 on the 8. Tittle takes it. Hands up to King, going wide. King cuts back inside the end, drives down to the 3-yard line, to the 2. And he steps the 2. It should be a first down in there, or very close to it. Time is called by the officials and by the Giants. Dale Schaffner is walking into the Giant locker room with a minute and 18 seconds to go in the first half. Schaffner is on his feet and walking into the locker room. We sure hope he'll be back out for the second half. But time has been called by the Giants, stopping the clock. Now we get to stay tuned at halftime for the latest worldwide news and up to the minute sports. Meanwhile, at Chicago, still in the second period, Chicago Bears 3, Detroit Lions nothing. Here's Al DeRogatis.
The footing at the end of the field where the Giants are now driving is much better than down here to our right side. The
right side to close in the Yankee Stadium is frozen. Now, on the last play, the guards both pulled very well and put a real good block, as did Joe Wolf. However, the significant thing was that Phil King was able to make that cut. He would have had a very difficult time had his team been driving in the opposite direction because of the frozen field. A real advantage.
Well, it's first and goal to go on the 3-yard line. 1 minute and 18 seconds remain in this first half. The Giants still have one more timeout left to them. They called a timeout earlier in the half. So it's first and goal to go on the 3. Kittle calling the signals at the line of scrimmage. Giffen flanked to the right side. Kittle takes the snap back, goes back to pass. Throws into the right corner, touchdown! Carson scores! A touchdown in the right corner! And Roy A. Kittle goes running off, snapping his hand as if to say, attaboy, attaboy! Tremendous spirit by the Giants and their fans here. The Giants are leading 15 to nothing. Meanwhile, Del Shonter has gone back into the locker room, and as he walks into the Yankee dugout and into the locker room, the fans there rose and gave him an ovation. One after attempt coming up. Teams are lined up and set. Gripping will hold. Chandler will boot. Ball is placed down and kicked us up, and it is good. There's timeout on the field with the score. The New York Giants, 16. The Pittsburgh Steelers, nothing.
When it came to defending home or country, the woman's role was traditionally passive. But the defense of freedom today requires such a complex structure that there are numerous opportunities for the American woman to take an active part in the service of her country. For the college graduate, these opportunities are even more inviting because she is eligible to serve as an officer in our Navy Wave. Today, all America recognizes the Wave officer as a woman who is more than dedicated to the heritage of her country. She has seen her duty and done something about it. She has told her Navy recruiter that she has wanted an honorable role, one with responsibility, one that she could fill with pride. She told her Navy recruiter she would like to become a Wave officer. If you're a college graduate, may we suggest you do the same thing? You'll be helping yourself and your country. See your Navy recruiter today.
At Yankee Stadium, Marty Glickman along with Al DeRogatis and Joe Hassel. A minute and 13 seconds remain in the first half. The Giants are out in front 16 to nothing. Ready to kick off now is John Chandler for the Giants. Twin safeties are Thomas and Foreman at the goal line. Here's the boot. It's short. Coming out of about the 15-yard line and it's taken there by Foreman. Foreman runs to his right. Up to the 20, he slips at the 28-yard line and down he goes. Pinned down by Eric Barnes. Eric Barnes in on the tackle, and it's first and 10 for the Pittsburgh Steelers. Ball is on the 29-yard line of the Steelers. Giants are out in front by a score of 16 to nothing. Now the clock is put back in motion again, a minute and 5 seconds to go in this first half. Up to the line of scrimmage come the white flat Pittsburgh Steelers, moving in towards the closed end of Yankee Stadium. Buddy Dyer flanked out to the left side. Ed Brown, the quarterback. Brown takes it. Hands off now to Foreman on an end-around play. Foreman going wide around his own left side, trying to make the turn up field, and he runs out of bounds at the 39-yard line. Picked up 10 yards on the play, and he couldn't stop. He jumped over the fence, a restraining barrier, back of the bench, because of the hard condition of the field, and into the snowy portion of the field, well back off the playing field. He picked up 9 yards on the play, 9.5. It'll be second and inches. The ball is on the 39-yard line. 49 seconds to go in this first half. Pittsburgh Steelers looking to get within field goal kicking range and, of course, looking to go all the way through if they can. On that play, Bowman playing the right end, came around on the reverse. An end-around play, circling his own left end. Buddy down off flank to the right side as Ed Brown goes back to pass, looking downfield. Goes down the middle, and it's caught by Buddy Dial at the 40-yard line, and down he goes, a fumble, a loose ball, with the whistle blew. And an official is knocked down by Mike Sandusky, who ran into him accidentally. The ball was picked up by Dick Pastinen, but the whistle sounded at the 38-yard line, 37-yard line of the Giants. And the Steelers called timeout to stop the clock. It'll be first and 10 at the 37 of the Giants when play is resumed, with 40 seconds remaining in this first half. Pittsburgh stops the clock now. And those Steelers are dangerous.
Buddy Dial going down and faking to the outside, going over the middle that time. Pulled down by Eric Barnes. New York Giants have 16 points. First, on a field goal by Don Chandler from 34 yards out. Then on a 41-yard pass play from Tittle to Schottner, climaxing a 66-yard drive. And then they moved 58 yards with the scoring drive, the scoring thrust being a 3-yard touchdown. A pass from Tittle to Morrison in the end zone. Here's a score for Chicago. Detroit has scored to lead Chicago in the second period. Detroit 7, Chicago 3. Detroit 7, Chicago 3 in the second quarter. Al DeRogatis.
More than likely now see the Giants go into their blanket defense, trying to take away any of the deep pass patterns from the Pittsburgh Steelers. So more than likely, we'll probably see Ed Brown forced to go over the middle short.
Here's the shotgun formation now for the Steelers. Brown, 8 yards back in the center, throws over to the left side, and it's caught inbounds by Press Carpenter at the 29-yard line. An 8-yard gain on the play. It'll be second and 2 on the 29 of the Giants. That's that shotgun formation, a spread formation, with Ed Brown, the quarterback, 7 or 8 yards back of the center. Both ends split, flanker backs on either side, and they're spread out all over the field on that particular formation. The line is also split about a yard and a half to each man at the line of scrimmage. Now they go into the T formation, second and 2 on the 29-yard line. 16-0, the Giants lead, 35 seconds to go in the half. Steele on snap, carries the ball, stumbles, runs to his right, trying to make the turn upfield, and down he goes to the 21-yard line, picking up 8 yards on the play, and the clock is stopped. Again by the Steelers, calling timeout. Ball placed down at the 21-yard line of the Giants. Good for a first down. He picked up 8 yards. They're on snap carrying until he was tackled by Dick Pessinen. And the Pittsburgh Steelers have moved upfield in a big hurry from their own 29-yard line after the kickoff following the Giants' second touchdown. Now to the Giants' 21-yard line. 27 seconds remain in this first half. And these National Football League teams are particularly adept in the final 2 minutes of the game or the half of moving that ball rapidly and conserving that clock. Al?
Well, I'm sure Ed Brown feels that actually the big thing to get his a TD. However, he will settle for a field goal, and he's not about to take any chances. So more than likely, knowing that the Giants are going to be playing, as I mentioned before, the deep spot for the TD isn't the likely thing. Ed Brown might just gamble, and he may try to come with a draw, figuring the Giants for a big, hard pass rush. And if he comes with that draw, again, as I mentioned earlier, the John Henry Johnson, this boy can really, really move.
Well, it's first and 10 on the Giants' 21-yard line. 27 seconds remain in this first half. Brown at the T formation, has flankers right and left. Takes the snap back, goes back to pass, looks downfield, throws near the goal line, incomplete, short. And intended for Gary Foreman, covered by Dick Lynch, and it was short, falling at the goal line, with Foreman about 3 yards in the end zone, and Dick Lynch covering Foreman. So it's second and 10 for the Pittsburgh Steelers on the Giants' 21-yard line. 22 seconds remain in this first half. And each time the play develops, you can hear the roar and the rise from the crowd. And perhaps yours truly too. No perhaps about it. Second and 10 on the 21-yard line of the New York Giants. The Giants are out in front 16-0. 22 seconds to go in the first half. Flankers are left and right. Brown takes it. Takes the handoff. Goes back to pass. Throws angling deep into the left corner. Incomplete to Bowman again. Incomplete. Deep into the left corner. So it'll be third and 10 on the 21. And as you said, Al, he's taking no chances. He's throwing that ball real deep. And making sure that there are no blue jerseys where that football is headed. Well, it's third and 10 on the 21. If they fail to make the first down or the touchdown on this play, the field goal attempt will be about 26 yards out. Or 27. See where they place it down. But that is still one play away. 17 seconds to go in this first half. 16-0, the New York Giants lead the Pittsburgh Steelers. Third and 10 on the 21. Brown takes it, goes back to pass. Looking downfield, being rushed, throws. The pass at the goal line, incomplete. So it's fourth and 10 on the 21. And Lou Michaels comes jogging in from the far side. 12 seconds remain in this first half. The Giants are out in front 16 to nothing. Lou Michaels has attempted two field goals thus far and has missed two field goals. And Ed Brown is going to be holding. Ed Brown from 27 yards out. Angle is two to the left. Keep the lineup and set. The ball is snapped. Place down. It's kicked. High enough, deep enough. It is good. So it's 16-3, and those Pittsburgh Steelers move from their own 29 down to the Giants' 21. And it all came within the last 2 minutes. Less than that, last minute and 18 seconds, as I recall. They really moved that ball smartly. And it's 16-3 now, with just 7 seconds remaining in this first half. The Giants finally gave up the score, a 27-yard field goal by Lou Michaels. Charlie Killett and Eddie Dove are in twin safeties. Joe Morrison back at about the 10-yard line. Those men, two men, Killett and Dove, have not played much in their cold. Joe Morrison, of course, has been in offensively all game. The running backs for the Giants have been Morrison and King, with no exception. 7 seconds remain in the half. The Giants are out in front 16-3. Now Michaels back there at his own 30. Begins to move forward, and the wind blows the ball off the kicking tee. There are occasional swirling whirlpools of wind on the field, and that time it blew the football off the kicking tee. Now it's set up again. Michaels moves forward to boot it, and he does. A floater coming down near the 10-yard line. Joe Morrison fumbles it and picks it up again on the 15 of the 20-yard line. Cuts inside of one man and another man to the 20 to the 25. Battles forward, he loses his helmet, and down he goes. At the 28-yard line, the gun should sound, ending this half. The clock has stopped showing 1 second as the ball has changed hands, but as soon as it's put back in, that gun should sound. And there it is. So that's the end of the half. The score, the New York Giants 16, the Pittsburgh Steelers 3.
Here with his between-half guest is Hank Greenwald. Hank?
When it comes to getting player talent, the New York Giants have taken a backseat to no one. And the man assigned to scouting the talent each year is their former coach and my guest here at halftime today, Jim Lee Howell. Many of today's Giants, of course, played under Jim Lee, who retired from the coaching end of it just 3 years ago.
Jim Lee, as a former coach, do you find yourself sitting at a ball game, coaching along with the coaches on the field? Do you find this is something that you're able to resist, or is it just something that you just almost have no control?
Oh, no. I'm pretty much a spectator, although I think I'm better than most spectators in that I do have a little more background than they have in the ball game. And I do notice as I watch the game, some fellow's out of position, or he's not playing his position quite correctly. And I just think what I would do if I would have been running the ball club in that situation. Not to second guess anyone, but I see that quite often now you think to see this thing happen two or three times, and pretty soon why you see that all the coaches on both sides are alert, and here they come, and you see the play that you're thinking about develop before long. And it makes it much more interesting, I think, watching the game, of course, because of that fact.
Must give you an awful lot of pride to watch some of the fellas who may have started their careers here with the Giants while you were coaching, and to see them develop as you watch them, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah. So that's, I think, one of the greatest satisfactions you get out of coaching is you work with the player, no matter whether it's a college level, high school, or pro. You have this association and fellowship and comradeship and the respect for each other, the players, the different position, and they in turn for the coaches. It's just something I think it's lacking maybe in some of the other fields. We have such great extent in coaching. That is a marvelous thing. And of course, being in the scouting business now, these boys that you have to go out and make an opinion on, a recommendation, it's nice to see them with all the other teams and the ones that make it and the ones that don't make it. That's also very interesting. It's very interesting to have coached some of the All-Star games and in the Senior Bowl. The best end I've seen in a long time come out of college was a one named Gil Cogdell. And he turned out the very next year to be the outstanding rookie of the year for Detroit. Then the next year, down in the same game, I have a boy named Aaron Thomas. And
you don't know about him, don't you?
So I thought he was even greater than Cogdell, and I have the highest regard for Cogdell. And I was very happy, of course, when the Giants were able to get him last year, and then to see him come along these last two or three ball games and justify all these high expectations for him. It really gives you a lot of satisfaction.
Kimberly Howell, I can't begin to tell you how pleased we have been to have the Giants games on our radio network and how much we're looking forward to being able to bring these exciting games to our many listeners for years to come.
Well, thank you very much. Of course, the Giants are very happy that you're doing this because it does take the game to more people who can't see it, and it's building up a genuine interest in football, and I know I catch it a lot on radio myself. Some of it even when I'm away, I tune in, and if I can't just be right there to the game or even after the game to get the rundown on the game, it's very important. You people are doing a wonderful job.
My guest here at halftime of today's game between the Giants and the Pittsburgh Steelers, Jim Lee Howell.
The Giants are on the near side, the Pittsburgh Steelers on the far side. A drill team completing its halftime entertainment and marching off the field out towards the open end of the stadium. Y8 Tittle, back of the bench, warming up. Throwing the ball to Joe Walton and to Hugh McElhenney. Y8 goes back a couple of steps, sets it, and then he throws downfield. Y8 wearing half basketball sneakers. Under the ankle, low-cut sneakers. They're black. Because we are accustomed to seeing Y8 with those old-fashioned high-top football shoes. Well, now the New York Giants go out to receive this kickoff. They lost the toss at the start of the game, and now they have the option at the start of the second half, and they are receiving, as Joe Hassel told you. The lights are on, as they have been, and although the sky is still a bright blue, we can see the effects of the sun's rays on some of the buildings in the background near Yankee Stadium. The field is entirely in shadow. There is even lighting on the entire field. Wind is swirling down on the field, but not severely and not with any great consistency. Now Lou Michaels is teeing up the football at his own 40-yard line, left-footed kicker, you know. Twin safeties for the Giants at the goal line are Killett and Dove. Joe Morrison of about the 10-yard line. Ready for the second half kickoff, Giants leading 16-3. And there's the boot, high and deep. This one is a good one. It hits the right upright, and it's an automatic touchback. So it's first and 10 for the Giants on their 20. Incidentally, the left upright, facing the upright from the playing field, blocked the point after attempt, the first point after by Don Chandler, and that's the reason why the Giants have 16 rather than 17 points. 16-3, the Giants lead. Now the Giants go to the line of scrimmage. We'll check that offensive unit for you and see whether or not Jack Stroud is in there. First and 10 on the 20-yard line. And the handoff goes to Phil King. King cuts up the middle for 5-6 yards. A trap play up the middle for 6 yards. Phil King carrying. And we see where Lane Howell is playing right back in the place of Jack Stroud. So the Giants offensively have Aaron Thomas at split end in place of Dale Schaffner. Schaffner is out here, though. And Joe Walton is the tight end. Brown and Howell are the tackles. Jess and Bolin the guards. Greg Lawson the center. The running backs, King and Morrison. The flanker back is Giffen. Y.A. Tittle, the quarterback. It's second and four on the 26. Giants four. Morrison takes it, finds the hole, goes upfield, picks up 6 yards, 7 yards. On first down for the Giants, up the middle, Joe Morrison carrying before he was stopped by Joe Cooper, the left tackle, and John Baker, the right end. First and 10 for the Giants. The ball is on the Giants' 32-yard line. 6 yard gain by Joe Morrison. Defensively, the Steelers have Lou Michaels and Joe Cooper on the left side. Frank Atkinson is the right tackle and John Baker the right end. That's the big four up front. Russell, Patios, and Schmitz are the linebackers. The handoff goes to Phil King up the line of scrimmage, and for a 2 yard gain, he goes up to the 34-yard line going off his own right guard. It'll be second and 8 on the 34 of the New York Giants. Completing the Pittsburgh Steelers defense The deep four are Glenn Glass, Dick Haley, Clinton Thomas, and Willie Daniels. So it's second and eight now for the Giants. The ball is on the 34-yard line of the Giants. The Giants are out in front 16-3. A minute and a half is gone in the second half. Tittle sends Thomas as a flanker out to the left side. Gibbon is a tight right end. Tittle, corner signals, ducks in under the center. Takes the snap back. Hands up to Phil King. King up the middle, goes for 1 yard up to the 35-yard line. It'll be third and seven on the 35. More action in the moment. The score, the Giants 16, the Steelers 3.
Oh, I like it. I'll take it. Where do I sign?
Just a moment, please, ma'am. I know it's a lovely home. It's got everything, and you'll be proud to own it. But to see if you can afford it and how to finance it, write for information on home financing, too. Home financing. Federal Housing Administration, Washington, D.C. Don't you think that's a good idea, wifey, dear?
It's your money.
7 for the Giants. On the Giants, 35 is Tittle. Goes back to pass. Throws back on the left side. And it's almost intercepted by Willie Daniel, but it's incomplete. Willie Daniel stepping in front of Aaron Thomas to go for the interception, but it fell between the two men. So it's 4th and 7 for the Giants on the Giants, 35. Giants pick up one first down, and now they're forced to punt. Twin safeties are Dick Haley and Clinton Thomas, ready to receive the kick, both wearing white sneakers. And Don Chandler backs up to his own 21-yard line, waiting to snap to center. 4th and 7 on the Giants, 35. Snap comes back to Chandler. He moves forward and boots the ball. A wobbly kick, fairly low, fairly shallow. Bounding down, hit by Greg Lawson. It bounded into Greg Lawson off the turf at the 34-yard line, and the Pittsburgh Steelers take over. 1st and 10 at the 34. Penalty marker may have been thrown down. Now let's see what the call is going to be here. Sam Huff, Bill King, still out on the field. Both out on the field, along with the rest of the Giants squad, offensively and defensively. And they're talking with the Pittsburgh Steelers, Mike Patios. And it may be against the Giants on that last one. I see what the call is going to be. Waiting for the signal from the official. A personal foul called against the Giants on the penalty refused. So it's 1st and 10 on the 34. Now the Steelers go to the line of scrimmage. The Giants are leading 16-3. Ed Brown is the quarterback. The defense is Johnson and Sapp. And the handoff goes to Sapp. Sapp goes off his own right guard, drives for 6, 7, 8 yards. Off his own right guard. Going up to the 41-yard line. Breaks down to the 42 it is. He picked up 8 on the play. Tom Scott made the tackle. Here on Sapp. Carrying the ball for 8. It's 2nd and 2 on the 42-yard line of the Pittsburgh Steelers. The Giants are out in front 16-3. 12 minutes to go in this third quarter. Steelers go to the line of scrimmage. Buddy Dyer flanked to the left side. The rest of the ball club is tight. Ed Brown goes back to pass on second down. Looks downfield, throws deep. Way down to Ballman, way down, incomplete. Overthrown. Ballman covered by Patton, but Ballman had a stride on Patton, and the pass is overthrown. More action in a moment. The score, the Giants 16, the Steelers 3.
Don't let an irritating cough or sore throat spoil the holidays ahead. Get soothing comfort from HB, Hospital Brand Cough Drops, the Happy Holiday Cough Drops. A favorite for over 50 years, HB Cough Drops are medicated for fast, sure relief. Look for them in the clean white HB box at your nearest drug or candy counter. Get HB Hospital Brand Cough Drops.
The Steelers 42-yard line, big play coming up. Buddy Dyer flanked out to the right side, Powers is in an end. Rest of the ball club is tight. The Giants are packed in front of me. John Henry Johnson carries a big hole. He's out of the clear. Sequence the only man who might catch him. Down to the 20-yard line. Looks going after him. Rolls him out of bounds on the 11, on the 10. On that play, the Giants are packed in solidly. And John Henry Johnson burst up the middle. And Dick Lynch had to come over from the weak side to come across and pull him down at the 10. Al DeRogatis.
Well, there it is, Marty. There's the danger of going into a real heavy defensive line. Once that fullback or halfback can get by the line of scrimmage, well, he's all the way to the safety. On the last play, He was barred to play a very side, as was Jimmy Patton. The only man remaining was Dick Lynch, and Dick had to come from the far side. Made a real good play.
First and goal to go on the 10-yard line. The ball is resting subtly on the 10. Ed Brown, call signals, hands up the Ciaran snap, trying to signal his own left end. He's hit and knocked down for a gain of 2 yards. Dick Pessner, a penalty marker. A penalty marker is thrown down. Trying to circle his own left end. Ciaran shot was hit by Pessner. Penalty marker is down. A 15-yarder against the Steelers. Al DeRogatis. Marty, Dick Pessner continues to do a real fine job. Now, when the Pittsburgh Steelers are putting on a running game where they're trying to go to the outside, to the side of a split end or to the flanker, it means that the right halfback or the left halfback will have to cover the split man on the pass. That means the safety, the inside safety man, has to put the force on it. Dick Pessner is doing a real fine job forcing the run. Back on the 25-yard line, Ed Brown goes back to pass, makes short, throws Angman on the right side. It's incomplete. In and out of the hands of Buddy Dial. Eric Foss, defending on the play, made a move and then stumbled and fell. And Dial reached up with one hand. The ball carried off his left hand and fell incomplete. So it'll be second and goal to go on the 25-yard line of the Giants. New York Giants, defensively, Cat Kamich, Modulevsky, Lovestier, and Robitelli. Hillebrand, Huff, and Scott, the linebackers, the deep four of Lynch, Patton, Pessinen, and Barnes. So it's second and 25 on the 25-yard line of the Giants. Buddy Dial flanked out to the right side. Gary Bowman put out to the left side. Ed Brown ducks in under the center, takes the snap back. A draw play to Johnson. Johnson running for 3-4 yards, and down he goes at the 21-yard line. It'll be third and goal on the 21-yard line. The draw play to John Henry Johnson with Jerry Hillebrand and Dick Modulevsky making the tackle. Offensively, the Pittsburgh Steelers have Sapp and Johnson, the running back. Buddy Dial, the flanker back. Ed Brown is the corner.
Johnson running for 3-4 yards and down he goes at the 21-yard line. It'll be third and goal on the 21-yard line. The draw play to John Henry Johnson with Jerry Hillebrand and Dick Modulevsky making the tackle. Offensively, the Pittsburgh Steelers have Sapp and Johnson, the running back. Buddy Dial, the flanker back. Ed Brown is the quarterback. The ends are Press Carver to the tight end. Gary Borman, the split end. Tackles Dan James and Charlie Bradshaw. The guards, Sandusky and Lennox. The center, Buzz Nutter. Third and 21 on the 21-yard line. Big play. Going back to pass is Eddie Brown. Looking downfield. Throwing deep into the right corner. It's caught at the goal line for a score by Borman. Gary Bowman gets it at the one and steps in. And Ed Brown had plenty of time to step back there, look for Gary Bowman, and he went in from the 1 yard line out of a deep right corner. The score is now 16-9, Giants over Pittsburgh. They only moved from their own 34. 66 yards for the touchdown. Here's the point after attempt coming up. Lou Michaels will try it. Teams are lined up and set. The ball is snapped, placed down, it's kicked up, and it is good. There's timeout on the field with a score. The New York Giants 16, the Pittsburgh Steelers 10. At Yankee Stadium once again, the crowd almost hushed as a result of that drive by the Pittsburgh Steelers. They look sharp and sure. Ready for the kickoff now by Lou Michaels. The Giants are leading by 6 points. There's the kick by Michaels, high and deep, coming down near the goal line. Killer takes it at the 2. Up he comes to the middle, the 10, the 15-yard line, along the left sideline, near the 20. He drives forward to the 23, fumble, a loose ball, but it's still Giants as the whistle sounded. Charlie Killer still had that ball. The tackle was made by Willie Daniel. Ball is at the 22-yard line, where it's first and 10 for the Giants, on the 22 of the Giants. Aaron Thomas in an end. Dale Schachter is not out there. He's on the bench. Now the Giants break the huddle, go to the line of scrimmage. Lane Howell playing right tackle in place of Jack Stroud. Flanker out to the right side of Giffitt. First and 10 on the 22 of the Giants. Tittle takes it, goes back to pass, takes a short one, throws a screen out to the left, incomplete. Intended for Joe Morrison. Joe Morrison, the intended receiver, a screen pass out to the left side, and the pass was thrown wide to Joe Morrison as Tittle was rushed hard.
Bob Smith rushing on the play. He's the linebacker. Al DeRogatis.
Bob Smith, Marty, very wisely, even though he realized the screen was coming, as soon as he saw Joe put that fake block on him, he tried to grab for Joe. Once he missed Joe, the big thing is to drive for the quarterback, and he really put on a big rush.
Second and 10 for the Giants. On the Giants, 22-yard line. Gifford flanked to the right side. Thomas split to the left. The handoff goes to King, trying to swing wide. He cuts inside the end, drives upfield, picks up 4 yards before he stops. Check that, 3 yards. Alex Webster is warming up on the near sideline, jogging up and down, talking to Coach Al Sherman. Joe Cooper came in, along with Mike Patios, to make the tackle. The ball placed down at the 24-yard line. It'll be third and 7 at the 24. The New York Giants leading in this ball game 16-10. But the momentum right now seems to have gone over to the Pittsburgh Steelers. Gifford flanked wide out to the right side. The rest of the ball club is tight. Third and 7 on the 24. Tittle takes the snap back, goes straight back to pass, being rushed, throws down the middle. It's caught by Gifford at midfield. A beautiful one-handed catch at midfield, and he goes forward to the 47. What a catch by Gifford. A one-hander reaching to his shoot-top to pull that in. Frank Gifford down and over the middle. A first down. It was third and 7. Talk about your big plays. Gifford came up with a magnificent catch. At top speed, he reached down with one hand, his right hand. He pulled it off his ankle top, and he was hit immediately by Glenn Glass. First and 10 for the Giants on the 47-yard line of the Steelers. Giants go to the line of scrimmage. Thomas flanked to the left side. The rest of the ball club is tight. Tittle ducks in under the center, takes the snap back. Rolls out to his left to pass, looks downfield, throws over the middle, completes the gift at the 30, down to 25, out of bounds at the 21-yard line. A beauty to Frank Gifford, going to the from right to left, over the middle, and the Giants are on the move down to the 22-yard line, is where he was forced out of bounds. That play was good for 25 yards, first and 10 on the 22. New York Giants in two quick plays. One for 29 yards, one for 25 yards, both to Frank Gifford. Gifford now goes out as a flanker to the right side. The rest of the ball club is tight. Tittle, the quarterback, on the steal is 22. Tittle takes it, goes back to pass, looking downfield, throws angry to the right side, completes the ball, but Morrison going all the way. Touchdown! One, two, three passes. Touchdown, Giants! Yards, 25 yards, 22 yards. Gifford, Gifford again, and then Morrison. And the Giants go out in front now, 22-10. They move 78 yards in six plays. Here's the point after attempt. Teams are lined up. Ball to snap, placed down and kicked. It is good. There's timeout on the field with a score. The New York Giants, 23. The Pittsburgh Steelers, 10.
In the crowd, a hubbub. As the Giants are out in front, 23-10, 8 minutes and 49 seconds remain in this third quarter. Don Chandler has teed up the ball, drops back to his own 32-yard line, ready to boot it. Twin safeties back there are Thomas and Bowman. Here's the kick, high, way up in the air, not too deep, coming down to the 10-yard line, taken by Clinton Thomas. He runs to his left, along the 15-yard line, missed by one man, running along the far side. A beautiful tackle to the 25-yard line. Charlie Killer with a beautiful tackle, right around the ankle. And now in Clinton Thomas. Good run back on the play. Ball is at the 25, 26-yard line, where it's first and 10 for the Giants. For the Steelers, rather. On the Steelers, 26-yard line. The Giants are out in front, 23-10. Steelers go to the line of scrimmage. Buddy Dow flanked wide out to the right side. Gary Borman split out to the left. The running back to Staff and Johnson. Ed Brown, the quarterback, takes the snap back. Gives off to John Henry. Henry trying to circle his own left end. Moves upfield for a couple of yards, and down he goes. Hit high and hard. Dick Lynch coming in, a flush of high and hard on his shoulder. Up to the 30-yard line. He picked up 4 yards on the play. It's second and 6 at the 30. Al DeRogatis.
Marty, once again, almost perfectly executed defensive maneuver. Tom Scott closing to the inside of Andy Robustelli. Andy taking it to the outside, getting a hand on John Henry, and then Dick Lynch coming up from that corner spot and finishing him off. Perfect positioning.
Second and 6 on the 30-yard line. Brown calling the signals, takes the snap back. Hands up the snap, running off right tackle, picks up 4 or 5 yards.
And down he goes 4 yards on the play. Up to the 34-yard line. And he's pulled down by Tom Scott and by Jim Patton. Running off his own right tackle. That running attack by the Steelers. Grinding out the yardage. He picked up four. His third and two. The ball is on the 34-yard line. Here's another big play coming up. Third and two on the 34 of the Pittsburgh Steelers. The New York Giants are out in front, 23-10. 7:20 to go in this third quarter. Bowman at the right side now. Dial flanks to the left side. Eddie Brown looking over the defense. Now he's under the center. Takes the snap back. Goes back to pass on third down. Throws deep. Deep down the middle. It's almost intercepted by Eric Barnes. In and out of the hands of Barnes. More action in a moment. The score, the New York Giants 23, the Pittsburgh Steelers 10.
This is Jack Benny. I'd like to ask you to remember that holiday time means Christmas seal time. Christmas seals on all our holiday mail to fight tuberculosis. Make sure there are Christmas seals on every card, on every package, to help protect everyone from TB.
It's fourth and two now for Pittsburgh on their 34. Ed Brown is back in punt formation on his own 20-yard line. Twin safeties for the Giants. Brown moves forward. Almost blocked. The kick is low. End over end. Rolling around near the 35-yard line, out of the 30-yard line, and it's picked up by one of the New York Giants, Nick Pessinen. He runs up along the left side, goes up to the 34-yard line, and he stops at the 34. The ball may have been kicked by one of the Steelers off around the 36-yard line, that's what it was. And it was blown dead there as it was kicked by the Steelers at the 36. So it's first and 10 for the Giants on their 36-yard line. The Giants are leading 23-10. Aaron Thomas still playing the split end. Joe Walton, the tight end. Dale Schaffner hurt in the first half, is on the bench. Bill King and Morrison are the running backs. Gifford the flanker. Y.A. Tittle, the quarterback. Tittle at the line of scrimmage, calling out to both sides. Now he ducks it under the center. He takes the snap back. Gives up to King. King opens on right guard. Drives forward for 4 or 5 yards. Up to the 39-yard line. And that's where he stopped, at the 39. Phil King carrying. Al DeRogatis.
Occasionally, the Pittsburgh Steelers defensive unit will play an overshift to the Giant weak side. In other words, they're putting their strength to the Giant weak side, figuring the Giants are going to come with a weak side running game. Very wisely on that particular play, wide, it'll hit to the strong side.
Gifford goes out of the flank on the right side. It's second and seven on the 39. Tittle takes it, goes straight back to pass, looks downfield. Oh, deep, a penalty marker on the play. And it's caught by Aaron Thomas, and he's pulled down at the 31. Pulled down at the 31-yard line. The Giants may be arguing, grabbing a face mask. Seems to be the signal. No, it's against the Steelers. A beautiful catch by Aaron Thomas at the 31-yard line of the Steelers. And let's see what the call is going to be. It may be from the spot of the down. And they may mark off another 15. They are, yes, sir. From the spot of the ball. Right down to the 15-yard line is where it is. A personal foul, grabbing the face mask of one of the Giants. So it's first and 10 for the Giants on the 15-yard line. Chicago has gone ahead of Detroit. In the third quarter, Chicago 10, Detroit 7. So it's first and 10 for the Giants on the Steelers' 15-yard line. New York Giants leading 23-10. 5:50 to go in the ball game. Gifford flanked to the right side. The rest of the ball club is tight. Tittle calls the signal. Takes the snap back. Goes back to pass. Throws angling to the right corner. Gifford's got it at the one. At the 1 yard line. He's out of bounds at the one. First and goal to go on the 1 yard line. Frank Gifford running it down and out. So it's first and goal to go on the 1 yard line. Some goal line defenders coming in for the Pittsburgh Steelers. Ernie Stotner is in there for greater weight and strength, as well as Frank Atkinson and Luke Cordleone. Well, it's first and goal to go on the 1 yard line. The Giants are out in front, 23-10. The Pittsburgh Steelers real tight in there. Y.A. hands off to Morrison, who dives in. Touchdown! The Giants go ahead, 29-10. Y.A. Tittle goes running off the field. Running off, again with that right-hand motion, as if to say, attaboy, attaboy. The Giants have gone
64 yards, 78 yards, in quick rush. And they lead now, 29-10. Here's the point after attempt. Seems a lot of the set. Ball is snapped, placed down, and kicked it up, and it is good. There's timeout on the field with a score. The New York Giants, 30. The Pittsburgh Steelers, 10.
Caused the death of about 150,000 Americans each year. Deaths from respiratory diseases are going up faster than any other type of disease. They're up 30% in just the last 5 years. Now, there's something you and I can do about this. Use all the Christmas seals you can this holiday season. When you use Christmas seals, your dollars now fight not only TB, but the common cold and other respiratory diseases. Christmas seals help to protect you and your loved ones. Won't you please answer your Christmas seal letter today?
At Yankee Stadium, with 5 minutes and 50 seconds remaining in the third quarter, the Giants are out in front 30-10. Don Chandler ready to kick off. Twin safeties of Thomas and Bowman back at the goal line. There's the boot. A short kick, end over end, coming down near the 15, and it's taken by Clement Thomas along the left side of the angle, back to his right, flips the ball at the 30-yard line. He has been down there by Bob Taylor, a rookie. Al DeRogatis.
Well, Marty, here's a situation where when you're in a crucial game like this, naturally, you'd love to be in this position. But it puts Pittsburgh in the position where they have to come out of the shell. They can no longer go with ball control. They've got to put the football up. And when you start putting the football up, well, then the ball game can break wide open again.
Well, it's first and 10 for the Steelers on the 30. Buddy Dial flanked to the right side. The rest of the ball club is tight. Going back. A handoff now to Gary Bowman on an end-around play. He's got 5 yards running along his own right side and drives up for 8 yards on the play before he stops. At the 38-yard line near the 40, you see where that ball is placed inbounds. Gary Bowman plays a tight left end. On occasion, Buddy Dial is flanked to the right side, and he comes around on an end-around. He picked up 9 yards on the play. It'll be second and one on the 39. Katkavich made the tackle. Yes, Al?
And Jim Katkavich, Marty, made a really great play. Mike Sandusky, 62, and Charlie Bradshaw, both leading the play. We're both trying to block on Kat, and he forced them both to the outside, waiting for a man to come over.
Ed Brown has the ball himself, goes up the middle for about the first down. He fumbled the ball momentarily, and then he moved up the middle himself to pick up the first down. Ball is now at the 42-yard line of the Steelers. First and 10 for Pittsburgh on the 42. 4.5 minutes to go in this third quarter. Dick Modulewski and John Lovettier made the tackle. Chicago has gone further ahead of Detroit. Chicago 17, Detroit 7 in the third quarter. Flankers are now left and right. Ed Brown takes it, goes back to pass. A quick pitch out to the right side, completes the dial, and he's knocked out of bounds at midfield. A sideline pattern, down and out to the right side. Knocked out of bounds at the midfield line by Eric Barnes. Play is good for 8 yards. It's second and two at the 50-yard line. New York Giants leading by a score of 30-10 as the Pittsburgh Steelers continue to grind out the yardage. The short passes and the running plays effective for Pittsburgh. Gary Bowman now is a tight right end. Buddy Dial flanked out to the left side. Press Carpenter to the other end. And the handoff goes to Sapp, trying to circle his own left end. He makes the turn upfield, picks up 5, 7 yards, and down he goes after picking up 7. Sam Huff, Jim Patton, and Dick Pesson combined to stop him. And again, the Pittsburgh Steelers continue this drive. It's first and 10 for the Pittsburgh Steelers on the New York Giants, 43-yard line. Pittsburgh Steelers break the huddle in their white uniforms with black and gold trim. They go to the line of scrimmage, driving in towards the closed end of Yankee Stadium. Flankers are right and left. Going back to pass is Eddie Brown, looking downfield. Moves down the middle. It completes the Bowman at the 28-yard line. He drives forward to the 25 before he stops at the 25-yard line. Jim Patton in on the play, along with Dick Lynch. Another first down, an 18-yard advance. First and 10 for the Pittsburgh Steelers on the Giants' 25-yard line. Al DeRogatis.
Gary Bowman, Mike, Marty is doing a really fine job. Now, this boy has got great speed. You have to cover him, giving him a little bit of room. Now, he may be trying to set up a fly pattern, figuring that the Giants may try to cover tight.
Ed Brown, the quarterback, calls the signal. Hands off to Sapp. Sapp trying to circle his own end. It's stopped at the line of scrimmage. No gain. Pretty play by Jerry Hillebrand, coming in along with John Lovettier. 3 minutes to go in this third quarter. The Giants out in the front, 30-10.
It's second and 10 on the 25-yard line of the Giants. Al DeRogatis.
Marty, once again, though, Jerry Hillebrand made the tackle. Dick Pessinen made the play. Dick came up from that safety position, reading run to the outside. Mike Sandusky, 62, leading the play, was the guy that Dick Pessinen picked off, enabling Hillebrand to fill from the inside.
Flanker out to the right side is dialed. The rest of the ball club is tight. Second and 10 on the 25. Going back to pass is Eddie Brown. Looking downfield, throws deep. Near the goal line. And it's intercepted by Eric Bond. Eric Bond decides to stay in there. He stays there. He started to come out, looked around. And Gary Borman, the intended receiver, was close to him. And so Eric Bond decided to stay put in the end zone and not run it out as he did in the first half. And the Giants have the ball as a result of a touchback. First and 10 on their 20. And as Al DeRogatis pointed out, with the Steelers trailing, the Steelers must take these chances, put that ball up in the air, and when it's up in the air, it's also up for grabs. First and 10 for the Giants on the Giants' 20-yard line. The Giants leading 30-10. A tight D with one exception. Aaron Thomas flanked to the left side. The running backs are King and Morrison. Y.A. Tittle calls the play. Hands up to Phil King. He busts it off his own left guard. Goes for 4 yards. Up to the 24-yard line. Al DeRogatis.
Y.A. Tittle, Marty, came with an automatic. Again, number 43, Glenn Glass, playing the left corner halfback, moved up to the line of scrimmage in what becomes a 4-4 defensive situation. Number 36, the left linebacker, Russell, for the Pittsburgh Steelers, moved up the middle as if the Red Dog. Y.A. called the automatic, but called it away from the strength of the Steelers.
Second and 6 on the 24. Kiffin flanked to the right side. The rest of the team is tight. Y.A. calls signals, takes the snapback, hands up to Phil King. King busts up the middle for 3 yards to the 27-yard line. More action on the moment. The score, the Giants 30, Pittsburgh 10.
Don't let an irritating cough or sore throat spoil the holidays ahead. Get soothing comfort from HB, hospital brand cough drops, the Happy Holiday cough drops. A favorite for over 50 years, HB cough drops are medicated for fast, sure relief. Look for them in the clean white HB box at your nearest drug or candy counter. Get HB hospital brand cough drops.
1 minute and 15 seconds to go in this third quarter. Third and 3 on the 27. Tittle thrown for a loss as he goes back to pass. He raised up, saw he could spot no receiver, and he was thrown down for a loss. Joe Cooper is the man in anchor for a loss, and now Cooper helps him to his feet along with Lane Howell. He's back on the 18-yard line. A 9-yard loss on the play. So it's 4th and 12 on the 18. A minute and 10 seconds remain in this third period. And Don Chandler comes in a punt now. Twin safeties back there for the Pittsburgh Steelers. Thomas and Haley. Chandler gets the snap from center. Kicks it. A good wobbly spiral. Fair catch called at the 46-yard line by Clendon Thomas. The 46 of the Pittsburgh Steelers. So Pittsburgh takes over. First and 10 on their 46. The Giants are out in front 30-10. 50 seconds remaining in this third period. Yes, Al?
The Pittsburgh Steelers have had their greatest passing success, it appears, on the first down situation. The Giants are placing for the run, but here Ed's come with the pass. Gary Borman again, very tough to cover deep, and he's also got a real good, quick inside move.
First and 10 on the 46 as Brown goes back to pass. Throws a quick sideline pass to the left side. A pretty catch by Buddy Dial. He fumbles the ball. It's loose and goes out of bounds to the far side. It was last touched by Buddy Dial. So it's still Pittsburgh ball to the Giants 40. They get the benefit of a forward roll that time of about 5 yards. Good for a first down. A fumble as he was hit by Dick Lynch. The ball rolling out of bounds and forward out of bounds for 5 yards. At the 40-yard line of the Giants. First and 10 for Pittsburgh on the Giants 40. The Giants leading 30-10. 35 seconds to go in this third quarter. Brown going back to pass. Looking downfield. Throws deep. Deep down to the left side to Dial. He's got it at the 5 for a touchdown. He outraced Dick Lynch. A touchdown, a beauty of 40 yards. With Buddy Dial running deep down the left sideline. Getting it on the 4-yard line. A stride in front of Dick Lynch for the touchdown. That makes it 30-16. Al DeRogatis.
Ed Brown obviously was testing on the play preceding the TD. He came with that quick pitch to the outside, again to Buddy Dial, seeing how close Dick Lynch was covering. They figured Dick was very close. They could beat him on the fly, and they did.
Teams are lined up for the point after attempt. Lou Michaels will try it. Signal's being called. The ball is snapped, placed down, and booted this up, and it is good. There's timeout on the field with the score. The New York Giants, 30. Pittsburgh Steelers, 17. The kickoff, high and deep, goes through the end zone. An automatic touchback, and Giants have the ball first and 10 on their 20-yard line. New York Giants lead, cut to 13 points, 30-17. Giants offensive unit again, with Aaron Thomas playing the split end, Joe Walton the tight end. Dale Sharpton was hurt in the first half. He's on the bench, but he's not been used thus far in the second half. Lane Howell playing offensive right tackle. That's the only change in the lineup. Those are the only changes. Y.A. Tittle takes the snap back, hands up to Phil King, trying to circle the end, moves upfield and up to the line of scrimmage, and that's all. Pulled down from behind on a good tackle on the play by Bob Schmidt. Lou Cordleone also in on the tackle. It's second and 10 for the Giants. The ball is on the Giants' 20-yard line. Giants have Rosie Brown playing left tackle and Lane Howell, the rookie from Grambling, at right tackle. Darryl Dess and Bookie Bolton in the guard, Greg Lawson in the center, as the gun sounds, ending the third quarter. That's the end of the third quarter with a score of the Giants 30, the Pittsburgh Steelers 17. Fourth quarter of the ball game now. The Giants out in left center field at Yankee Stadium, heading in towards the closed end of the stadium. They're out in front of the Pittsburgh Steelers 30-17. It's second and 10 for the Giants on the Giants 20-yard line. Play has not yet resumed. In the fourth quarter at Chicago, Chicago leads Detroit 17-7. These final 15 minutes of play will determine the Eastern Division champion, just as the final 15 minutes at Chicago this afternoon determine the Western Division champion. They meet for the title 2 weeks from today in the home of the Western champion, December 29th. Giants were leading by as many as 20 points, then 16-3 at halftime, 30-10 before that last Pittsburgh touchdown. And now the Giants huddle up. Y.A. Tittle calling the play in that huddle. It's second and 10 on the 20-yard line. Now they go to the line of scrimmage. Giffords flanks out to the right side. Aaron Thomas split out to the left side. Tittle looking over that defense. Ducks in under the center. He takes the snap back. Goes back to pass on second. Throws the screen out to the left side. Complete to Morrison. He has a blocker. Moves downfield. Up he goes. Up to the 28-yard line. And down he goes finally at the 28. A screen pass out to the left side. To the 28-yard line. So it'll be third and 2 on the 28. Mike Patios and Bob Schmidt combine to stop him. Joe Morrison taking that screen, picking up a block from Greg Lawson and from Darryl Dess. Third and 2, big play on the 28-yard line of the Giants. Giants are out in front, 30-17, 14 minutes and 25 seconds to go on the football game. Giants break the huddle, they go to the line of scrimmage. Giffords flanked to the right side, Thomas split left. The running backs are King and Morrison. Tittle looking over the defense, ducks in under the center. He takes the snap back, hands up to King, running up his own right tackle. He drives upfield. He's short of the first down by a yard, up to the 29-yard line. So it'll be fourth and 1 on the 29, and the Giants will force the punt. Don Chandler goes jogging out on the field. Y.A. Tittle comes striding off to the near sideline. Twin safeties for the Pittsburgh Steelers, Thomas and Haley, Clendon Thomas and Dick Haley. Pair of 5- and 6-year veterans. Don Chandler back on his own 15-yard line. Ready for the snap from center. The Giants are out in front, 30-17. He gets the snap from center. This is Chandler, and he boosts that ball. It's a good one. A high, twisting spiral taken at the 26-yard line by Haley. Haley runs to his right, and he's pulled down by Greg Lawson. A beautiful tackle. Lawson coming in at full steam, pulls it down at the 22-yard line. Haley was bellying back to his right, but Greg Lawson cut him down at the 22. First and 10 for the Steelers on their 22-yard line. The Giants leading 30-17. 13 minutes and 20 seconds to go in this football game. As the Steelers break their huddle, go to the line of scrimmage. Buddy Dyer flank wide out to the left side. Lynch covering him out here. Ed Brown takes it. Hands up to Sapp. Sapp goes off left guard. Drives up for 3 yards up to the 25-yard line where he's stopped by Dick Modzelewski. It'll be third and 7 on the 25-yard line of the Pittsburgh Steelers. The Giants out in front, 30-17. 13 minutes to go in the football game. 13 minutes to go, and the Giants lead by 13 points. Andy Robicelli calling a defensive signal, slapping his hands together, exhorting his own defensive ball club. Third and 7 on the 25. Dial flanked out to the right side now. The rest of the ball club is tight. Brown calls signals, takes it, gives off the snap, trying to swing wide around his own right end, and he's pulled down. No gain. Jerry Hillebrand. Jerry Hillebrand in on tackle beautifully. So it's third and seven on the 25-yard line. Al DeRogatis.
Marty, once again, I've got to point out the job that Dick Pettin is doing. This boy is really moving up there from that safety position on so many of the runs. The Steelers are playing a wide split with their flanker and their end. That means the halfback will have a difficult job of making the force on the run. So this is up to the safety, and Dick Pettin is doing a fine job.
Third and seven on the 25. Brown joins back to pass, looking downfield. Throws angry to the left side. Overthrown, too high, intended for Gary Bowman. So it's fourth and seven on the 25. More action in a moment. The score, the Giants 30, the Steelers 17.
Music to plan your future by.
Count up, count up, count up your savings bonds. See how fast they count up.
Yes, United States savings bonds to keep freedom in your future. Also a great way to feather your own nest egg. Buy savings bonds.
Ed Brown back in front formation on his own 10-yard line. Pearson and Dove and twin safeties back on their own 35. Snap from center, and Brown boots that ball, a bad kick, over to the far side, bounding down near midfield, rolling around near the 50-yard line, and the Giants are all away from it. The Steelers around the ball. A poor kick, and it finally rolls dead at the 48-yard line of the Giants. As a score from Chicago, Detroit has scored, and in the fourth quarter, the Bears 17, Detroit 14. First and 10 now for the Giants, on the Giants' 48-yard line. The Giants are out in front, 30-17. They snap to the line of scrimmage. Y.A. Tittle sends Gifford out as a flanker to the right side. Tittle takes it, goes straight back to pass, fakes short, throws deep, deep way down ahead, and Thomas had it overthrown, incomplete at the 10-yard line. Thomas covered on the play by Clendon Thomas. They are not related. That's Aaron Thomas for the Giants, and Clendon Thomas, of course, for the Pittsburgh Steelers. Well, it's second and 10. On the New York Giants 48-yard line, Frank Gifford goes running back in on the huddle, says something to Y.A. Tittle. Al DeRogatis.
Part of the strategy on the last play, Y.A. figured that the Steelers were going to be playing very tight. He figured the halfbacks, and he figured right, they were going to be playing way up to the line of scrimmage. The Giants figuring again a running situation. And Y.A. tried to go with a big bomb, and it was a gamble, but it could have worked.
Second and 10 on the 48, Y.A. at the line of scrimmage. Takes the snapback. Hands up to King. King busts up the middle, goes for 7-8 yards. A loose ball, a fumble. Recovered by... Let's see now. I see the Steelers recover. The Steelers have recovered the ball. It's at the Steelers' 46-yard line. And down at the bottom of the pile for the Pittsburgh Steelers is John Baker. He made the recovery on the fumble by Phil King. So the Steelers take over. It's first and 10 on the Steelers' 46-yard line. Time remaining... 11-20. 30-17, the New York Giants are out in front. Now the Steelers go to the line of scrimmage. First and 10 on their 46-yard line. Ed Brown, the quarterback, looks over the defense, ducks in under the center, takes the snapback, a double reverse. Press forward to carry the ball, trapped back there for a loss, and down he goes at his own 43-yard line. A 3-yard loss on the play. Robustelli, Lovettier, and Huff on that double reverse didn't fool any of the Giants, and he was pulled out for a loss. Back to their own 43. Second and 13 on the 43. Yes, Al?
The onside tackle, Marty, the tackle to Andy Robicelli's side, gave the play away because as soon as the man went in reverse away from Robicelli, the blocker tried to put a block on Andy to the inside. Andy played the pressure to the outside.
Flank is right and left as Ed Brown goes back to pass. Second and long yardage. Throws down the middle and is caught by Gary Foreman at the 45 of the Giants. A pretty catch. He's held upright by the Giants. The ball is played down at the 44 of the Giants. Mighty close to a first down. And it is a first down. First and 10 for the Steelers on the Giants' 44-yard line. And Ed Brown threw a bullet right over the middle. Right into the breadbasket of Gary Bowman in the end. Now Dial flanks wide to the right side. Bowman has slipped to the left side. First and 10 on the 44. Brown, the quarterback, takes it. Hands up to John Henry Johnson. He spins down the line and goes for 3 yards. Down on the 41-yard line of the Giants. It'll be second and 7 on the 41. Sam Huff and Andy Robicelli stop the play. 9 minutes and 50 seconds to go in this football game. The Giants are out in front, 30-17. Pittsburgh has the ball, second and 7 on the Giants' 41-yard line. Al DeRogatis.
Ted Brown, Marty, likes to begin to develop a pattern here. He likes to come with a quick pass to either Dial or to Bowman, and then after that he goes on a fly. We might watch for a fly pass to Gary Bowman.
Going back to pass is Eddie Brown, looking downfield. He's seeing left. He throws into the right side, and it's incomplete. Coming in hard, Jim Kent, Cabbage, and John Lovettia rushing Ed Brown, and Brown threw over the sideline on the right side, incomplete. Intended for John Henry Johnson. So it's third and seven for the Pittsburgh Steelers on the Giants' 41-yard line. And the clock has stopped with 9 minutes and 29 seconds to go in this football game. The Giants are out in the front, 30-17. At Chicago, the Bears lead Detroit in the fourth quarter, 17-14. How more exciting come the National Football League championship yet? Eastern Division title and the Western Division title at stake today. Up to the line of scrimmage now come the Pittsburgh Steelers. Dial flank wide to the right side. Going back to pass is Brown, looking downfield. Throws aiming to the left, and it's caught for a first down. Incomplete, ruled incomplete. He was knocked out of bounds. It was caught, but he caught it out of bounds. The receiver, Gary Bowman, made the catch all right, but he had to have both feet in bounds when he came down, and he was out of bounds. The pass was complete, but out of bounds. So it's fourth and seven on the 41, and it looks as though Lou Michaels will try a field goal. Ed Brown is in there, so is Lou Michaels. It may be a fake as well, and Jim Patton is the only man going back, and he's not going back too far. It's going to be a 48-yard attempt if it is. Teams are lined up, ball is snapped, placed down, and kicked. It's up high enough, and it is caught by Jimmy Patton at the goal line. He runs out to the 5, to the 10, up along the near sideline, to the 15-yard line. He gets good luck to the 20, the 25, a penalty marker, the 30-yard line, and out of bounds at the 35. And out of bounds at the 35. May have been clipping back there. Let's see what the call is going to be. The kick was short, and the ball is going to be brought back because of a clipping infraction against the Giants. A beautiful run back by Jim Patton, but it's nullified by a clip. It'll be half the distance to the goal line, I believe, 15 yards from the spot of the foul. That should be, and it's placed down at the 8-yard line. So the Giants have the ball, first and 10, on their own 8-yard line. 9 minutes and 14 seconds to go in the game. The Giants lead 30-17. Big plays coming up. Y.A. Tittle at the line of scrimmage. Takes the snap back, gives off to Morrison, trying to swing wide. He makes the turn, cuts the field, picks up 4 or 5 yards before he's down. A pretty run by Joe Morrison, battling upfield. Clendon Thomas made the tackle. Ball placed down at the 16-yard line. Picked up 8 yards on the play. Hugh McElhenney comes into the lineup now, replacing Phil King. For the first time, the offensive unit has changed in the backfield. It's second and two on the 16-yard line. Y.A. Tittle calls the signals. Takes the snap back. Gives to Morrison again. He cuts off his own left guard. Out on the cliff for the first down. And down he goes at the 25. Big plays for the Giants. First and 10 for New York on the Giants. 25-yard line. Al DeRogatis.
Marty, as you called it, Joe is making some really big plays. And Joe Morrison, up front, there is no distinctive hole. The Steelers are doing a real good job. But Joe Morrison, very wisely, keeping his balance and picking his hole. And the last two successive plays has picked the right one.
Gifford flank wide out to the right side. First and 10 on the Giants, 25. The Giants leading 30-17. 8:05 to go in the game, 8:05. Tittle goes back to pass, looks downfield, throws on to the right side, completes the Gifford at the 40-yard line. How about he goes? Gifford actually fell down, going downfield. He slipped as he made his cut. He picked himself up, and now he makes the catch at the 40, and he's knocked out of bounds there. Frank Gifford playing a magnificent football game today. First and 10 for the Giants. On the Giants' 40-yard line. This series began back on the Giants' 8. Now they're up to their own 40. 7 minutes and 59 seconds remain in this football game. Giants leading 30-17. McElhenney and Morrison on the deep back. Thomas flanked very wide out to the left side. The rest of the ball club is tight. The handoff goes to Morrison. Up the middle, he breaks in the clear. Up to midfield, down to the 45, down to the 41. Another first down. Forward action of the Mullet. The score, the Giants 30, the Steelers 17.
Need Christmas gifts for men? White Owl cigars are always a hit. White owls are beautifully gift-wrapped in a wide range of prices, $1.68 to $4.75, and easy to find at your local drug, food, and tobacco stores. Give White Owl, and you'll make his Christmas a merry one.
7.5 minutes to go in this football game. Thomas Plank wide out to the left side, 1st and 10 on the Steelers, 41. Hand off goes to Hugh McElhenney. McElhenney up the middle, no gain on the play. He's held upright by two of the Pittsburgh Steelers. So it'll be 2nd and 10 on the 41-yard line as the clock continues to run. 7 minutes and 10 seconds remain in the game. Joe Cooper and Mike Patios with a pair who held Hugh McElhenney upright. Offensively, McElhenney and Morrison, the running backs. Frank Giff is the flanker back, and what a game he has played today. Y.A. Tittle, the quarterback. The ends of Thomas and Walt. The tackles are Lane Howell and Rosie Brown. The guards, Destin Bolden. The center is Greg Lawson. 2nd and 10 on the 41-yard line. Gifford split out to the right side. Flank to the right side now. Rest of the ball club is tight. Tittle goes back to pass. Looks downfield. Throws angle to the right. Completes the Gifford at the 31-yard line. A first down. Another first down for the Giants. I don't know who's going to get that Kinney Carr Award this week. Dick Lynch won it last week, but that Gifford show will be in contention. 1st and 10 on the 31-yard line of the Pittsburgh Steelers, and the New York Giants have moved from their own 8 to the Steelers 31, and the clock continues to go. 6:38. Up to the line of scrimmage come the New York Giants, driving in towards the closed end of Yankee Stadium. Tight D with one exception, Thomas flank wide. Tittle goes back to pass, throws. Angles the left foot, a lead pass to Morrison, too long. Morrison out of the clear, the pass thrown by Y.A., and Y.A. has taken his helmet off, and he was jumping up and down, stamping his feet like a little kid who had been refused some candy. Y.A. knew he had Joe Morrison out in the clear. He let him just a little too much. The play was incomplete, but Y.A. is so mad at himself, he took off his helmet and literally jumped up and down, stamping his feet. It's 2nd and 10 now on the 31-yard line of the Pittsburgh Steelers. The Giants are leading 30-17. Giants huddled up. Bill King up off the bench talking to Coach Al Sherman and to Kyle Rhodes. Giants go to the line of scrimmage now. Gifford's flank right, Thomas split left. 2nd and 10 on the 31. Tittle calling out of the line of scrimmage, maybe an automatic. Takes the snap back. A draw play to Joe Morrison. He runs off his own left guard, drives downfield, goes down to the 23-yard line. Picks up 8 yards. It'll be 3rd and 2 on the 23. We pause for station identification. This is the Giants Football Network.
Your dial is set at 810, the smoothest sound around. WGY Schenectady.
Now it's 3rd and 2 for the New York Giants on the Steelers 23-yard line. In case you're interested, the ball is midway between the sidelines. 5 minutes and 55 seconds to go in the game. Tittle calls the signal, takes the snapback, goes straight back to pass, being rushed. Throws out to the right side to Morrison. He dropped it. Joe had it in his hand. The same pattern as at the left side when the pass was overthrown. This time it was not overthrown, but fell into Morrison's hands directly from over his head. A very tough catch to make had he made it, but he dropped it at the 10-yard line. The ball came directly from over his head. He had to turn almost all the way around to watch that ball come down, and he couldn't hold on. And now a field goal attempt from 29 yards out straight away. 29 yards out straight away. The Giants leading by 13. Seems to set. Ball snap. Placed down. It's kicked. High enough. Deep enough. It is good. No good. No good. Wide to the left. And Don Chandler is arguing vociferously, but to no avail. 5 minutes and 42 seconds to go in the game. A fine drive by the Giants from their own 8-yard line down to the 23. And the Steelers take over 1st and 10 on their 20. The score, the New York Giants 30 and the Pittsburgh Steelers 17. 5 minutes and 42 seconds to go in this football game. Now the Steelers hustle to the line of scrimmage. Buddy Dial flanked to the left side. Gary Bowman split to the right side. Going back to pass is Brown. He hands off to Stapp. Stapp on a draw play up the middle. Picks up 7 yards, 8 yards. Dick Modulewski and Sam Huff combine to stop him. 7 yards it was on the play. It'll be 2nd and 3 on the 27. And the clock is running with 5:20 to go. 5 minutes and 20 seconds remain in the ball game. The Giants are out in front by those 13 points. Dial flank wide out to the right side. Going back to pass is Eddie Brown. Looking downfield, throwing deep. Way down the middle, Jimmy Patton is. He intercepts on the 30-yard line. Along the near sideline, to the 35, to the 40. Cuts back to his left and down he goes at midfield. Giant ball. First and 10 at midfield. Jimmy Patton made the interception, a big one. Gary Foreman made the tackle. First and 10 for New York at the midfield line. Jimmy Patton making his sixth interception of the season. Clock is running, 5 minutes to go. First and 10 at midfield. The Giants are out in front, 30-17. Out at Chicago, the Bears lead Detroit, 17-14. Giffen flanked out to the right side. The rest of the ball club is tight. Y.A. Tittle turning to call back to his backs, McElhenney and Morrison. And the handoff goes to McElhenney. He pulls away from one man, gets to the line of scrimmage, spins upfield for 4 yards, 5 yards. Down he goes, picking up five. He was stuck at the line of scrimmage, pulled away, and drove for 5 yards. Second and five at the 45-yard line. Mike Patios, the middle linebacker, made the stop on Hugh McElhenney, the great veteran of the University of Washington, now in his 12th year of the National Football League, getting the chance to play in this very important ball game. Second and five on the 45 of the Pittsburgh Steelers. The Giants out in front, 30-17. 4 minutes and 5 seconds to go in the football game. Y.A. Tittle running the ball club. Hands off to Morrison. Morrison drives for the first down. 7 yards. 8 yards on the play. Down to the 37-yard line. Joe Morrison up the middle for a first down. Stopped by Clendon Thomas and Willie Daniels. First and 10 on the 37 of the Pittsburgh Steelers. Clock is running. 3 minutes and 45 seconds to go in the game. Up to the line of scrimmage come the Giants now. First and 10 on the Steelers, 37. Y.A. Tittle looking over the defense. Gifford is flanked right. Takes a snap back, hands up to Morrison. Morrison drives to the middle, goes inside the 35 to the 34. Picks up three on the play. Joe Krupa makes the tackle. It'll be second and 7 on the 34-yard line. Here's second and 7 on the 34-yard line. New York Giants are out in front, 30-17. 3 minutes and 5 seconds to go. Giants in their huddle, taking the maximum amount of time. Now they go to the line of scrimmage. Aaron Thomas flanked to the left side. McElhenney and Morrison are deep. Rest of the ball club is tight. Handoff goes to Morrison, runs off his own right guard, stops at the line of scrimmage. No gain, a 1 yard loss on the play. Back to the 35-yard line. Ernie Stoutner came charging in, and the Pittsburgh Steelers have called for a timeout to stop the clock. When play is resumed, it'll be third and 8 on the 35-yard line. The time remaining, 2 minutes and 42 seconds. Giants have the ball, third and 8 on the Steelers' 35-yard line. 2 minutes and 42 seconds remain in the game, and the Giants are out in front by 13 points, 30-17. At the moment, Y.A. Tittle is at the near sideline with timeout, talking to Al Sherman and Kyle Rhodes. Rest of the five, the offensive unit on the field. Dale Schaffner has not played in the second half. He was hurt in the first half after scoring one touchdown and setting up a second touchdown. Jack Stroud played in the first half, was taken out in the second quarter, and Lane Howell, that fine rookie from Grambling, who's 6'5 and 265 pounds, has played all at right tackle since the early part of the second quarter. The rest of the ball club has been fairly intact with one additional exception. Phil King has played three quarters of the ball game, but Hugh McElhenney is in there now at the halfback position. McElhenney and Morrison are the deep backs. 2 minutes and 38 seconds to go. The Giants are out in front, 30-17. Here's the final score for Chicago. Here it is over the PA. Chicago wins it. Chicago 24, Detroit 14. The Chicago Bears have won the Western Division Championship 24-14, beating Detroit today 24-14, and beating out Green Bay for the title. Now it's third and 8 on the 35-yard line. Tittle takes the snapback. He's going back to pass, looking downfield, throws a screen out to the right, complete to Morrison, and he has two blockers. He moves downfield and is knocked out of bounds at the 34. The play only picks up a yard or two. And he's knocked out of bounds to stop the clock with 2.5 minutes to go. Andy Russell knocked him out of bounds. Well, let's see now. Don Chandler is in there. So is Glenn Griffin. A field goal attempt coming up. It'll be from 40 yards out. with the Giants leading by 13. It's going to be 40, 41 yards. Let's see now. The angle is to the left. Okay, 41 yards. The teams are lined up and set. Griffin call signals. Ball of snap, placed down his kick. It's high enough and deep enough, and it is good! It's good! The Giants go out in front, 33-17. And half the Giants fans goes out on the field to congratulate Don Chandler. A 41-yard attempt, and the Giants lead 33-17. Instead of a 13-point lead, it's 16. Time remaining, 2:25. Don Chandler went into this ball game tied for the individual scoring lead, and he may move ahead as a result of the points he scored today. But right now, the Giants are out in front 33-17. Clendon Thomas and Gary Bauman ready to receive the kickoff. Here's the boot now by Chandler, high and deep, coming down right to the goal line between the uprights, taken by Thomas. He runs to his right to the 10, 15, cuts back, up the middle, he comes to the 18-yard line, and there's a handoff, and down they go. Tress Carpenter carrying it on the handoff for a moment at the 18-yard line. Charlie Killett and Ken Byers combine to make the tackle. So it's first and 10 for the Pittsburgh Steelers. The ball is on the 18-yard line. The Giants are leading 33-17 with 2 minutes and 14 seconds to go, and the clock is put back in motion again. The clock is running. Pittsburgh Steelers are huddled up. Up to the line of scrimmage they come now with Buddy Dial flanked out to the left side. And with 2 minutes to go, there's an automatic timeout. The officials notify both benches that 2 minutes remain on the football game. Half of this crowd is on its feet now, calling out to the New York Giants. The Giants having this very substantial lead, 16 points, 33-17 the score, with 2 minutes to go on the ball game. Giants led from the outset, and the Steelers threatened time and time again. Now play is about to be resumed. They're going into the shotgun formation. Eddie Brown, 8 yards back of the center, gets the snap from center, looking to pass, throws down the middle, and it's caught at the 30-yard line by Gary Bowman. Down he goes at the 30. It's good for a first down. First and 10 at the 30-yard line of the Pittsburgh Steelers. Tackle made by Sam Huff and Dick Lynch, and the clock is running. 1 minute and 40 seconds to go on this football game. Steelers snap out of the huddle, and they stay on that shotgun offense. Both ends split, flankers left and right. John Henry Johnson, only man blocking back there for Brown now. Brown throwing deep, way down the left side. Dick Lynch defending, and he knocks it away. Dick Lynch knocks it away on the pass intended for Buddy Dial. So it's going to be second and 10 on the 30-yard line of the Pittsburgh Steelers, and the clock has stopped with 1 minute and 24 seconds to go in the game. The Giants 33, the Pittsburgh Steelers 17. Steelers go running back into their huddle. Al DeRogatis and Joe Hassel have made their way down into the Giant locker room. Now Buddy Dow comes again as a flanker to the left side. Red Mack is in the lineup now. He's split out to the right side. Again, the shotgun offense. 9 yards back of the center now. Snap comes back to Eddie Brown. He throws angrily to the left side, and it's complete to Carpenter, who runs out of bounds. He could have picked up additional yardage. No one was near him at the moment. He runs out of bounds at the 43-yard line of the Steelers to stop the clock at 1:20. So it's first and 10 for Pittsburgh on the Pittsburgh Steelers 43-yard line. The New York Giants leading 33-17. The clock is stopped with 1 minute and 20 seconds to go. That's 80 between the Giants and their third consecutive Eastern Division championship. 80 playing seconds. Red Mack flanked to the right side along with Gary Bauman. Put out to the left side, Buddy Dial, shotgun offense. Going back to pass again as Brown being rushed now. Throws way down the right side. And it's deflected and knocked down by Eric Barnes. The intended receiver, Red Mack. Eric Barnes knocking that one down. That ball thrown 60 yards in the air, diagonally downfield against the Giants. Way up in the air and diagonally out to the right. Falling incomplete around the 15-yard line. It'll be second and 10 on the 43-yard line. 1 minute and 12 seconds to go in this football game. Second and 10 on the 43. As the Steelers go to the line of scrimmage. The Bears have won their football game. The championship 2 weeks from today at Chicago. Going back to passes, Eddie Brown. Throws angling to the left. Almost intercepted. Knocked down, deflected by Tom Scott. Scott making a fine defensive play. So it's third and 10 on the 43-yard line. 1 minute and 7 seconds to go. Of course, after each incomplete pass, the clock is stopped. Or each time a ball carrier runs out of bounds, the clock is stopped. Giants are out in front, 33-17. Red Mac runs back into the lineup. New York Giants leading by 16 points. Up to the line of scrimmage now come the Pittsburgh Steelers. Mac flanked wide out to the right. Shotgun offense. Buddy Dial split to the left. Ed Brown gets a direct snap to center. Goes back to pass. Throws a screen. It's deflected and incomplete. Deflecting that pass was Jimcat Cabbage. He leaped high in the air to knock it away, and it fell incomplete. So it's fourth and 10 on the 43, and of course, the Steelers aren't going to be punting now. Or maybe they will. A minute and 3 seconds to go in the football game. As the whole change of a unit out there, the Pittsburgh Steelers punting unit comes out, but they may well be passing. No sense in giving up the football now. Ed Brown is the punter, and of course, he is the passer. Only a single safety, Dick Pessinen back there. Fourth and 10 on the 43, a minute and 3 seconds to go. And Brown is kicking the ball. And Pessinen lets it bounce in front of him at the 30. It rolls back along the 25-yard line now and finally rolls dead at the 25. That's a surprise. 52 seconds to go in the ball game, and Glenn Griffin goes in. Glenn Griffin is in the lineup at quarterback. It's first and 10 for the Giants. The defensive unit comes off. And they're being pounded and patted. The hands are being jerked. And Y.A. Tittle is being given a big hand. He has run out on the field, thinking he'd stay in. Allie Sherman embraces him. First and 10 on the 25. The clock is running. 35 seconds to go in the ball game. All the Giants have to do is run one play. Griffin on a quarterback keep pulls that ball. And the whistle sounds. With 25 seconds to go, Charlie Killett goes into the lineup now. Let's see, he replaces Joe Morrison. And Morrison gets a great hand. The clock is running. Listen to this crowd now with 10 seconds to go. They'll start the count. The Giants have won it. 33-17, and the Giants are being mauled. The goalposts are being shaken, and they'll come down in just a moment or two, and the Giants are trying to battle their way into their own locker room. The Giants have won it 33-17. A terrific football game played by Pittsburgh, but the explosive Giants offensive thrust was just too much. When Pittsburgh came to within 6 points of the Giants, Y.A. Tittle pulled that ball club with three consecutive pass plays. One to Gifford, another one to Gifford, and then to Morrison for the touchdown. 78 yards for the touchdown, and that was the big difference. And the goalposts on the closed end of the field are down, and there are enough special policemen at the open end of the stadium at the goalposts there to see that they remain upright. But the Giants have won the Eastern Division Championship for the first straight year. We're going to get down into the locker room and listen to the Giants with Joe Hassel, Aldi Regattis, and Kyle Rudd. It should be a happy place to be. So take it away in the Giant locker room.
And come on, everybody. Smile. Have a Valentine's beer. You get a smile every time. In the heads of taste of a Valentine, piccolos and banjo, smile for me. Trumpets and clarinets, lively. Trombones and xylophones, get happy. Come on, everybody, liven up your living. Lively Valentine, you get what beer was meant to give. Good taste, good time. So get a smile every time. Smile, enjoy the heads up taste of a Valentine beer. Best beer for smiles around.
New York Giants are the 1963 Eastern Conference champions, victorious over Pittsburgh this afternoon, 33-17. Joe Hazel is in the dressing room. He moved down there very rapidly. Let's see if we can pick up Joe Hazel while we prepare for Kyle Rote's regular dressing room analysis. Joe Hazel.
Hold on just a minute now. Here, we'll try to pick this up. Father Dudley is now.
Well, we're going to attempt to bring in, I hear Kyle Rote is down there and Joe Hazel, and they're evidently preparing for our locker room broadcast when we will have an opportunity to talk with some of the players and the coaches. At Yankee Stadium, New York City, you're listening to New York Giants Football, a feature presentation of Ivy Broadcasting Company and this radio station. Brought to you this afternoon by HB, Hospital Brand Cough Drops, for fast relief from throat irritations. Breath sweetening, too. For a tickle, a cough, or a wheeze, say HB's, please. By P. Valentine & Sons, Newark, New Jersey, brewers of Valentine beer. You get a smile every time in the heads-up taste of Valentine. By the famous Milder White Owl Cigars, easy to find at your local drug, food, and tobacco stores. Also brought to you by these local people.
WGY 810 on your radio dial. Want to whistle through the morning and hum through the afternoon with relaxing, easy listening? Then tune in to Randy English Show from 10 a.m. to 12 noon and from 1 p.m. to 3:30 every weekday. Then you know why we call WGY the smoothest sound around.
Speaking for Marty Glickman, Al DeRogatis, and Joe Hazel, this is Woody Erdman inviting you to stay with us for the post-game wrap-up, when we will attempt to bring in Joe Hazel and Al DeRogatis, followed by Kyle Rote's locker room report, coming up next on this station on the New York Giants Football Network.
810 and you dial the smoothest sound around. WGY Schenectady.
I want to tell you about a Greek boy named Peter. Peter was sent to live with relatives last year because his family was unable to provide for him. But his parents couldn't bear the separation, and now Peter's back home. This 6-year-old Greek boy faces winter without clothing that he needs. But Peter never complains. He knows that his parents can't afford to buy him any clothing. If you gave Peter and his family food, they would be able to eat for a week, perhaps a month, and then be hungry again and in need of more help. But if you helped Peter and his family buy a flock of chickens, the family would soon have food to eat and income from the sale of the eggs with which to buy clothing and other necessities. For information on how you can help a family like Peter's to help itself, write to Save the Children, Box 120, New York 17, New York. That's Save the Children, Box 120, New York 17, New York. Thank you.
The New York Giants 33, the Pittsburgh Steelers 17. That's the final score of today's game. This is Bill Neal, along with Woody Erdman, with some of the scores of this weekend's professional football games and a report from the locker room, a very excited locker room in the New York Giants dressing room in New York. This portion of our broadcast brought to you by Burke and Laurie Incorporated of New York for the John F. Kennedy Memorial Album, and by this local sponsor.
WGY 810 and your dial in Schenectady, where high-scoring entertainment comes your way every weekday morning on Breakfast with Bill at 7 o'clock. Verbal first downs happen faster than a quarterback sneak when Bill Edwardson mans the mic. For all-round entertainment all day, every day, tune in 810 on your radio dial.
Well, the New York Giants defeated the Pittsburgh Steelers this afternoon, 33-17, and thereupon they became, for the third consecutive time, Eastern Conference champions in the National Football League. And with Chicago's victory over Detroit this afternoon, the Bears and the Giants become opponents 2 weeks from today in Chicago for the National Football League championship. In this game this afternoon, Pittsburgh took the kickoff to open the game, and on the first play from scrimmage, fumbled. The ball recovered by Giants defensive star Jim Patton. After three unsuccessful attempts to score a touchdown while deep in Steeler territory, Don Chandler initiated the scoring for the Giants with a 34-yard field goal. And so the Giants had an early lead 3-0 over Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh and Gary Borman ran back the Giants' kickoff after the field goal. Borman went 57 yards on the run back from the Steeler 15 to the Giants 28. However, Pittsburgh gained only 4 yards in 3 plays, and so Lou Michaels was called upon to attempt the field goal. He failed, and the Giants took over on their own 20. The Giants in the next series fumbled, and the Steelers recovered. Pittsburgh quarterback Ed Brown passed to Borman on the 15, who carried to the 1, where he fumbled, and whereupon Eric Barnes of the Giants picked it up and carried it out to the Giants 34. The Giants, after that sensational defensive play, executed the series, climaxed by an equally thrilling, perfectly thrown 41-yard pass pulled in by Del Schaffner on the goal line and carried in by Schaffner for the score. The extra point attempt by Don Chandler hit the left upright and fell no good. The Giants' first touchdown drive was good for 66 yards, and New York increased the lead. It became the Giants 9, Pittsburgh nothing. By the way, that pass established a new record for touchdown passes completed in a season, the 34th completed by Tittle this year, breaking his own record of 33. An intercepted Steeler pass by Dick Lynch on the Giants' 10 was carried out to the Giants' 44 by Lynch. Pittsburgh, however, intercepted a Giants pass on the Steelers' 2 to stop the drive that at one point had New York on the Pittsburgh 5 with a first down situation. The first quarter ended with no further scoring, and it was New York 9, Pittsburgh nothing. In the closing minutes of the second quarter, a 45-yard pass play by Tittle and Schaffner moved the ball from the New York 42 to the Steelers 13. A draw play up the middle and wide to the outside moved the ball to the 8, and then another ground carry took it to the 4. Whereupon, Y.A. Tittle passed to Joe Morrison in the end zone for the second Giants touchdown and the second of the game. Giant Chandler made the conversion, and New York had a 16-0 lead. Pittsburgh entered the scoring column with just 1 minute and 18 seconds remaining of the first half, moving the ball from their own 29 to the Giants' 21-yard line. Lou Michaels, with the 21, the line of scrimmage, booted a 27-yard field goal, and the Steelers had broken the scoring ice. It was New York 16, Pittsburgh 3, and that's the way the half ended. We'll take a look at the second half after we hear from Bill Deal. Bill?
Ask not what your country can do for you. Ask what you can do for your country. Now these sounds of history, these words of greatness, these words no assassin's bullet could still, are yours in a special limited edition record album. Now you can live again the memorable moments, hear again the famed familiar voice, our late president's actual speeches, the complete inaugural address, civil rights, Cuban crisis, and other highlights. This John Fitzgerald Kennedy memorial tribute on a 12-inch high-fidelity long playing record is encased in a beautiful album jacket featuring a full-color presidential portrait suitable for framing together with eulogies by Cardinal Cushing and other dignitaries. A record royalty on this album will be donated to charity. To obtain your memorial album, send just $3 for each album to John F. Kennedy Memorial Record, Department G, 356 West 40th Street, New York 18, New York. Only 3 records to a family, please. Mail $3 for each record to John F. Kennedy Memorial Record, Department G, 356 West 40th Street, New York 18, New York.
Well, for those of you who have just joined us, the New York Giants have won the National Football League's Eastern Conference title for the 3rd straight year, and the Chicago Bears are the Western Conference champions of the National Football League. They will meet 2 weeks from today in Chicago. We had reviewed the scoring up to halftime, at which time the Giants were out front 16-3. In the second half, the Pittsburgh Steelers continued their scoring ways initiated in the closing seconds of the second quarter. After New York could not score, having received the second half kickoff, Pittsburgh took possession and moved the ball from their own 34-yard line 66 yards for the touchdown. Gary Borman scored the TD after taking a pass from quarterback Ed Brown. Lou Michaels made the conversion. The Steelers were very much in the game, 16-10. The Giants, however, came back but good. As a matter of fact, the series started on the Giants 22, and Y.A. Tittle moved his team 78 yards in only 6 plays. The final 3 plays were all pass completions to Gifford for 27 and 25 yards consecutively. And then the 22-yard scoring pass
to Joe Morrison. Chandler kicked the extra point. At this moment, Giants fans felt a great deal better, the score then being New York 23, Pittsburgh 10. The Giants were on the move, and on the move they stayed. After the touchdown came when Joe Morrison went over from the one-yard line, after the Giants had moved 63 yards, Morrison scored from the one. Chandler again made the conversion in this touchdown for the Giants, and Giants fans at this point had good reason to be jubilant. New York's lead over Pittsburgh was then by 20 points, New York 30, Pittsburgh 10. Well, if the Steelers were expected to call it quits, those who expected this were disappointed rather quickly following that Giants score. Pittsburgh, with time running out in the third period, climaxed the scoring drive with a 40-yard pass completion to Buddy Dow from quarterback Ed Brown. Lou Michaels added the extra point, and Pittsburgh had reduced the gap to 13 points. The score as the quarter ended was New York 30, Pittsburgh 17. The New York Giants took out additional insurance with 2 minutes and 25 seconds remaining in the ballgame. Don Chandler kicked an angle to the left 41-yard field goal. Chandler entered the game, the league's scoring leader, and at this point had today added 9 points to the previous total. The final score accordingly became New York 33, Pittsburgh 17, the third consecutive Eastern Conference championship for the New York Giants in the National Football League. And with Chicago's victory over Detroit, the Bears and the Giants become opponents 2 weeks from today in Chicago. We'll wrap up this postgame show in just 60 seconds.
Across the nation, it's gift-giving time. Store windows are bright and shoppers crowd the streets. Tempting ads make choosing difficult, and often we hear the expression, for the man who has everything. Now here's a further suggestion. This year, why not add to your list the man who has nothing? Send food for him and his family through CARE. Hunger seems most tragic this time of year, yet it is the very season when supplies are apt to run low. Refugees, orphans, disaster victims, the jobless, especially need help. CARE has plans to deliver 6 million special food crusade packages to the neediest of these in 19 countries. But CARE asks the public to share by giving a dollar per package. Remember, the man who has nothing. With dollars to CARE Food Crusade, New York, New York, zip code 10016. Remember, every dollar sends a package in your name to CARE. Here again, Woody Erdman.
As we mentioned, if you have just joined us, the New York Giants have won the National Football League's Eastern Conference title for the third straight year. Led by veteran quarterback Y.A. Tittle, the Giants trounced the Pittsburgh Steelers at Yankee Stadium this afternoon 33-17. The Chicago Bears are the Western Conference champions. The Bears clinched their first divisional title since 1956 by defeating the Lions 24-14. Chicago finished its season with a record of 11 wins and 1 loss and 2 ties, 1/2 game better than the Green Bay Packers. The Bears will meet the Eastern Conference winners, our Giants, in the NFL's title game in Chicago, December 29th. As far as details of the Bears game is concerned, Billy Wade passed for both Chicago touchdowns, hitting Johnny Morris with a 51-yarder and Mike Ditka with a 22-yarder. Roger LeClerc kicked 1 field goal and 2 extra points. Dave Putzel killed off Detroit's chance by intercepting a pass and returning it 39 yards for a TD in the closing minute. Stay tuned now for the locker room report with Kyle Rote, Joe Hazel, and Al DeRogatis.
Thank you very much, Woody Erdman. This is Bill Deal inviting you to stay tuned for that Kyle Rote report from the dressing room. This portion of today's Giants broadcast is brought to you by Bruck and Laurie Incorporated of New York City for the John F. Kennedy Memorial Album, and by this local sponsor.
WGY 810 on your radio dial. Want to whistle through the morning and hum through the afternoon with relaxing, easy listening? Then tune in the Randy English Show from 10 a.m. to 12 noon, 1 p.m. to 3:30 every weekday. Then you know why we call WGY the smoothest sound around.